I'm sure they would like, but defensively they need him.
Next up for Indiana will be Xavier. They beat New Orleans. The Privateers go out in round one. Louisville over Delaware today. The four seed in the Midwest advancing with that 6-point margin. And Oklahoma State, Big Country, Brian Reeves had 26 points. And Eddie Sutton's team now into the round of 32. Here's a look at the Midwest bracket at Indianapolis.
Well, tournament time, you think of Bobby Knight, but Eddie Sutton pops up there. Sound defensively. Louisville better be on their game.
Okay, now here's the lineup for tomorrow. It's quadruple header Saturday, and Raf promises it will not be an average margin of victory
we'll
of 25 points like tonight, right? Okay, here we start out with a single game.
Of the team, particularly Nova.
Baskets very early in the ball game, and then got another couple, I think, very early in the second half. During the time that Brian was on him, he had a very tough time scoring. We thought that that Brian moved well with him. He did a good job. Brian has not played as well as a starter as we'd like to see him play, as certainly he's going to have to play next year. He has come in well a lot of times off the bench and played. We'll change that a little bit and see what he does as a starter here this afternoon. Trying to match up as well as we can against Xavier's big men.
Coach, I know this has pleased you all season long, but this team has really done a good job when you brought kids off the bench and maintaining what you've set out to do.
Well, I think that we've had a small bench, four guys, and now we're all the way up to six guys on the bench with Henderson playing some against Wright State. In all that time when we just had four players on the bench, each of them, many different times, made very significant contributions to our play, and many times in the first half of games where had they not been able to do so, we would have been in a difficult position at halftime, and they prevented that from occurring, and then usually went on then again to play well in the second half of the game.
Coach, how about lineup-wise today?
We'll go with Graham, Greg Graham, Bailey, Cheney, Evans, and Nover, but we'll be doing a lot of maneuvering around too, Don, depending upon what they're doing and how the game is going and what it is we're trying to accomplish at any given time.
Bob, best of luck in today's ballgame.
Thank you.
This has been the Bob Knight pregame show with discussion and commentary on today's game. In the Midwest Regional here at the Hoosier Dome. Now this is Don Fisher inviting you to stay tuned for today's broadcast.
You're tuned in to exciting Hoosier basketball right here on WNJY Joy 103. Stay tuned as Don Fisher brings you all of the play-by-play from the Hurrying Hoosiers in the NCAA right here on Joy 103.
Beaver Dam Inn in Monticello is the place for exquisite prime rib and scrumptious seafood. Visit Beavers now for their nightly dinner specials, exceptional service, and delicious homemade soups. While you're there, ask about their catering and private party services. Located just south of the Norway Dam, everyone's eager to eat at Beavers. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Call 583-8375. The Beaver Dam Inn.
Goody Sports Center is always bleeding red for the Indiana Hoosiers, and they'll bleed red for you too. Goody Sports Center, located in downtown Monticello, is your total sporting goods headquarters, even if your favorite colors aren't red and white. If it has anything to do with sports, Goody's has it. Whether it's shoes, sweats, jackets, or any kind of sports equipment, you can get it at Goody Sports Center. Goody's, located in the Shoppers Concourse, 103 South Main in downtown Monticello. Call 583-3009.
Logan Sports Ford Lincoln Mercury, the affordability store, has the number one best-selling car in America. Plus, they have the number one best-selling truck in America. Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury has great selection, a pleasant atmosphere, affordable quality service, and guaranteed no high pressure. Their goal at Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury is your total satisfaction. Nobody makes it more affordable than the Logansport Ford Lincoln Mercury Store, located at the east end of the Logansport Mall.
A law firm that believes integrity comes first. O'Brien and Morrissey wants you to know about their law practice located at 1015 Bank One Building in Lafayette. You can talk to Thomas O'Brien or Michael Morrissey with your first consultation free. They can assist you in divorce, personal injury, real estate, wills, estates, drunk driving, and criminal cases. Meeting the legal needs of the people in our area, O'Brien and Morrissey. Call 317-742-9027.
Chevy's, Logan Sports' most popular nightclub, invites you to rock and roll to the greatest hits of the 50s and 60s every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. Yes, Chevy's friendly atmosphere, unbelievable lighting, and outstanding sound makes for a good time for everyone. Now it's...
seed in the Midwest, Indiana. The go-to guy for the Musketeers is 6'8 center Brian Grant. He poured in 20 points in the first round win over...
This is exciting Indiana University basketball. Today's game brought to you in part by Indiana Gas. For efficiency, comfort, and a cleaner environment, natural gas is your best energy value season after season. By your local Napa Auto Parts store, Napa because there are no unimportant parts. By your local Amoco Soda Care Repair Centers. By the Hoosier Lottery, where you've got to play to win. By State Farm Insurance and the more than 500 State Farm agents throughout Indiana. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By the real estate professionals at the 121 Century 21 offices in Indiana. By True Value Hardware. Got a tough job? You can do it with True Value Hardware stores. And by Tricep Herbicide, PPI Weed Control that puts you in control. Hello again, everybody. This is Don Fisher along with Max Skirvin welcoming you to second round play in the Midwest Regional of the 55th annual NCAA College Basketball Tournament. This afternoon, the Hoosiers of Indiana, the number one seed in this region, meet the Musketeers of Xavier University out of Cincinnati. Ranked number one in the country and 29-3 on the year, Indiana ripped the Raiders of Wright State 97-54 to gain this matchup, while Xavier pulled away from New Orleans with a 73-55 triumph that pushed their season mark to 24-5 after first-round play. Well, Max Skirvin, Xavier is a team that has been ranked this year and has a valid reputation as a giant killer on this floor here in the Dome.
Don, you're quite right about that. As a matter of fact, they're 4-1 here in the Dome and have had great success. And, of course, they've been an awfully good NCAA tourney team since Pete Gillen came along. They're certainly one you have to take seriously.
Well, this will be the seventh meeting in the history of these two schools, with Indiana owning all six previous victories, the last back in the 1979 season, 92-66. We'll be back to take a closer look at today's game in a moment and talk with Xavier coach Pete Gillen right after we pause for the 60-second network timeout.
The football players, the fans, and certainly the coaches expect IU to have a winning season. It takes 100% effort from everyone to make the season successful. Varsity Club members support this winning effort by their generous gifts to the scholarship fund for the football team and 17 other varsity sports. The athletic department receives no tax dollars to support the program. We pay the bills through the generosity of our fans. Help the Varsity Club have a winning season with your gift. With your 100% effort, along with the hard work of our players and coaches, how can we lose?
Remember the first grade? 1-1 is 2. 2-2 is 4. It was all so simple. Not anymore. Appreciation, depreciation, computers, ever-changing tax and business issues. Put a CPA on your team. Today's certified public accountants are masters in the art of science, maximizing the potential of your money and improving profits. Contact a CPA in your area or the Indiana CPA Society. CPAs make a difference.
Well, back once again at the Hoosier Dome in downtown Indianapolis, Indiana, and Xavier about to match up this afternoon in this NCAA second round game of the Midwest Regional. We had a chance to talk with Xavier's coach Pete Gillen yesterday about his ball club.
Well, we've had the same problem for 2 days in a row, Max.
Well, we'll see what we can do about that. I can hear the fans down at the end of the hall over here to our left. The IU team must be about ready to come out because they start getting ready about 20 or 30 seconds before they actually
just
appear.
Just a couple of comments about your ball club. I saw them for the first time this year outside of television on the MCC championship ball game against Evansville. Then I saw them last night. Two different ball clubs.
Well, we played a lot better last night against New Orleans. Evansville's a very good team. They can make you look bad. So, we have been fortunate to beat them twice, but they played really well, and they deserved to win last Saturday. Last night, I thought we played a great second half. First 10 minutes shaky, but real good the last 30 minutes.
Can you talk a little bit about this ball club overall this season? You've had an excellent, excellent campaign.
Yeah, we improved a lot from last year. 15-12 with a young team. We had some, adversity, some injuries, and our kids really worked hard in the offseason, April, May, June in the weight room, open gym situations, and worked hard in preseason. So I think it's hard work. Everybody improved 5 or 10%, nothing dramatic.
You've got both an inside and an outside attack.
We do. We have great big guys inside, and we have, good perimeter players. So I think we're very talented. We don't have a superstar like a Calbert Cheney or, some of the players in the country, Bobby Hurley, but we have some very talented players.
Talk a little bit about this ball club and what you like to do offensively.
Well, we like to get some cheap baskets. We like to run the break, push it up, try to go to the offensive boards, try to get a balance inside-outside. You can't live with just one thing. So we try to get it inside to our big guys. They double down, which Indiana will do, kick it out, try to get some press. So we try to get a balance, and we try to attack the basket. We try to be aggressive.
You do different things defensively?
Yeah, we change up. We don't do one thing well. We play man, some zone, different defenses. We're not as complicated as we were in the past. In the past, we used to play five or six. Now we just play, one or two.
Can you talk a little bit about this Indiana ball club that you're going to face?
Well, every superlative you want, they have. Number one in the country, player of the country, best coach alive, dead, or yet to be born. What else do you need? You got a surgeon, you got Dr. Kildare, you got Spassky. What else? You're playing as... They would have beaten anybody in the country last night, as you know. They were just a machine. So we got to hopefully, get the machine out of sync somehow, all right? Or we'll pull out the lights in the Hoosier Dome and go get a beer.
All right, that is Pete Gillen as we talked to him yesterday about this ball club. He's got a lot of quips, Max, and he does the same old job that Lou Holtz does it at Notre Dame. He tries to badmouth everybody into non-existence out there.
He likes to badmouth himself as much as anybody else, how poor things are and all this kind of stuff. You got to be aware of him because he's a sly character. He's got a good basketball team.
We'll be back to talk more about the ball game. We'll look at the starting lineups in a moment. But first, let's pause for the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Professional interiors. What does that mean? Well, according to Funk and Wagnall, professional means skilled in a profession, art, or craft. Interior means pertaining to the inside. Now, what it doesn't mean is expensive. At Professional Interiors, you'll find the best prices on the best brands of carpet anywhere. So don't be surprised if you find that high-quality carpet that you saw elsewhere and thought you couldn't afford priced so low that you'll wonder how the other guy sells any of it. Professional Interiors, 570 South Main Street in Monticello. The best carpet and better prices.
McGreevy's Pizza King, a place where your lunch hour is your time. Come in, sit down and relax. Choose from a large selection of super sandwiches, delicious salads, and sensational soups. Let them bring the food to you. McGreevy's Pizza King wants you to enjoy your lunch hour. For your next lunch break, enjoy McGreevy's Pizza King on the square in Delphi. McGreevy's Pizza King, more than just great pizza.
Indiana and Xavier about to do battle here at the Hoosier Dome in the second round of the Midwest Regional. And Max, there is no lack of upsets so far in this NCAA tournament.
Don, this has really been one of those that I think even more upsets than you normally have. I can't remember when name teams have been beaten this early and as many of them, but I do think that probably helps coaches like Bob Knight get his team ready. All he's got to say is, hey, look at so-and-so and so-and-so. If you're not ready to play, you're going to come out of this thing.
Well, certainly Xavier is a ball club and is very dangerous. They have a great record, 24-5, 12-2 in the MCC. They beat Evansville twice in the regular season. Lost them maybe in one of their poor performances in the MCC tournament.
The fact that they've played Evansville probably is going to help them a great deal, because Jimmy Cruz, of course, the disciple of Bob Knight, uses much the same system. He just doesn't have quite maybe the talented players Indiana has, but that might help them a bit.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see whether Xavier can hang with the Hoosiers or not. If they can, it'll be an interesting ball game, no doubt. And the one thing Bob Knight talked to his ball club about before this ball game today, this is going to be a 40-minute game, he said. You're not going to be able to let up one moment. You're going to have to play hard the entire 40 minutes because Xavier won't let you do anything else.
Well, I think they proved that in their New Orleans game. You remember the score was tied in that game, and, man, they came back and really took it to New Orleans in the second half. They're not one that will quit.
Well, let's look at the starting lineups for today's game. First of all, for the Xavier Musketeers under Pete Gillen, now in his eighth season, the forwards are Aaron Williams, a 6'9", 225-pound senior from Evanston, Illinois, and Michael Hawkins, a 6-foot, 173-pound sophomore from Canton, Ohio. They list him as a forward, but he'll actually play as the third guard. Ryan Grant at 6'8", 245, a junior from Georgetown, Ohio, is in the middle. Jamie Gladden, 6-foot, 170 senior from Lorain, Ohio, at one of the guard positions. And Steve Gentry at 5'11", 174, a junior from Cincinnati, Ohio, at the other guard spot. For Indiana this afternoon, Bob Knight changes things around again. Today at forward, he'll go with Brian Evans at 6'8", 211, a freshman from Terre Haute, along with Calvert Chaney at 6'6", 204, a senior from Evansville. In the middle, Matt Nover, the 6'8", 230-pound senior out of Chesterton, Indiana, and the guard spots will be manned by Greg Graham at 6'5", a senior out of Indianapolis, and Damon Bailey, the 6'3", 200-pound junior from Heltonville, Indiana. So Indiana starts Brian Evans today after his best performance in some time in the ball game on Friday against Wright State, in which he scored in that contest 10 points and pulled down 9 rebounds, was it, Max?
I don't have a box score right in front of me, but yeah, I think 9 was the number.
All right, we'll be ready for the tip-off of today's ball game in a moment, but first, let's pause for the 60-second network timeout.
To defend your soybeans against weeds, you need power. You need control. You need consistency. You need this squadron. Squadron Herbicide, for a higher level of soybean weed control. See your Cyanamid AgriCenter dealer. Read and follow label directions.
In the Hoosier State, State Farm is there with free discounts for Indiana homeowners. If your house is just a few years old, you get a new home discount. Install a smoke alarm, a fire extinguisher, and deadbolt locks, you get a home alert discount. When you're with State Farm 3 years, you get an automatic discount. A State Farm agent is there to help you save on your homeowner's insurance.
State Farm is there.
The officials for today's game are Larry Lembo, Tom Lopes, and Charlie Range for this contest, as Indiana and Xavier about to do battle in the second round of this Midwest Regional. Jumping center for IU will be Calvert Chaney, the 6'7 senior out of Evansville. And Aaron Williams, the 6'9 senior from Evanston, Illinois, will jump in for Xavier, and the Hoosiers control the tip. Greg Graham has it in backcourt across the timeline and drives it to the left side, brings it back out to the top of the key on the dribble to the right against Xavier's man defense right now to Brian Evans. He slides it back to the top of the lane, goes left to Graham. Graham lets a three fly and got it. Greg Graham scores the first three of this ball game with the Hoosiers around the board first. Now up the floor, Steve Gentry for Xavier. Gentry gives it off to Aaron Williams. Williams goes left side to Hawkins, down low to Grant. Grant kicks it back out to Hawkins, who drives it left side of the lane. He holds on the baseline, cross courts it to Grant. Grant back in front of Aaron Williams, and Williams lost it out of bounds, but there's a foul call against IU. So a personal is nailed on the Hoosiers right here at the outset, and I think they nailed Calvert Chaney. Chaney was in early foul trouble against Wright State on Friday, and again he gets his first in the ball game here in the first 40 seconds. Aaron Williams will go to the free throw line, the senior out of Evanston, Illinois, averaging 10.7 a game, but he had a great contest against the New Orleans Privateers. He scored a career-high 20 points in that ball game. Good free throw shooters, just about everybody on the Xavier ball club, and he missed it. So Aaron Williams misses his first attempt from the line, Indiana leading 3-0. Xavier trying to get on the board here with Williams at the stripe. Second toss, good. Williams' first point. Indiana up 3-1. Full court pressure applied by Xavier, at least by one player. That's Jamie Gladden against Bailey. And Bailey crosses the timeline with it. Gets it right to Brian Evans in the corner. He'll bring it back out to the wing. Now off to Calvert. Lost the handle. Ball batted up in the air and pulled out of there by Grant. Stolen back by Greg Graham. Inside to Bailey. Fakes, puts the shot up, blocked away. And Xavier's got the basketball. Down the floor, this is Gladden, or right there, Gentry off to Gladden on the left wing. Now back off to Gentry, who takes it left side, down low to Williams, turns underneath, puts it up, and missed it. Rebound battle for, Gentry's got it for Xavier. Back out it comes to Gladden, he lets it fly, he misses the shot, the rebound to Brian Evans. Make it Matt Nover. Nover clears to Bailey, who goes to Graham. Baseline drive, puts it up, score! Ray Graham's second basket, and Indiana leads it 5-1. Now the other way, the Musketeers. Gentry to Williams in backcourt. Now right side to Hawkins. Hawkins holds, gives it outside to Gladden, top of the key. Gladden goes left side to Gentry, down low to Williams, turns it back outside to Gentry, now kicks it to Gladden. Gladden tries to take it inside. Looked like a travel, but he got away with it. Now Grant has it. Outside pass, almost deflected by Cheney, picked up by Gentry. Again goes Gladden, left side to Grant, jump shot good. Ryan Grant scores his first two of the ball game, and that's the first field goal for the Musketeers at 5-3. Here's the inbound. It goes to Greg Graham from Bailey, and he'll cross the timeline with it against Hawkins. Graham in backcourt, top of the key dribble. Greg still moving with it, looking for Calvert, finds in the ball, batted away, picked up by Brian Evans. Evans down the dribble, outside, goes to Greg Graham, right wing. He fakes the jumper, jumps it inside to Calvert. Fadeaway shot is up and in. Calvert Sandy's got his first two. The Hoosiers have the shooting eye going early. Now it's 7-3. Gladden lobs into Grant, who turns on over. Back out it comes to Gladden. He's looking for the 1-2-man game here. Now off to Hawkins' left wing. Down low at the Aaron Williams on the baseline. He moves it back outside to Gladden. Gladden slides it back out to Hawkins to Gentry. Gentry on the hold, starts the dribble left. Passes to Grant, top of the key. Grant goes outside to Gladden. Gladden now slides it to the left wing on the dribble, still moving with it, comes back in the lane, kicks it out to Hawkins, who fires the three, got it. Michael Hawkins hits the first three of the ball game for Xavier. The inbound comes to Greg Graham against some full court pressure, but it's light as Graham will cross the timeline. Indiana leads 7-6. Here's Damon Bailey, right wing. Tosses back out to Graham. Graham starts to slide it left. Back off right to Bailey. A zone being used now by Xavier. Here's Bailey off to Greg Graham, right wing. Three on the way. Good. Greg Graham has got eight. And boy, is he hot again. He returns to form after a ball game where he was off his feet just a touch. The inside play to Grant. Grant turns. Lost the handle. Whistle blows. Foul call. And Greg Graham will be whistled on this one. So Graham has picked up his first, second team foul whistle against IU. The Hoosiers lead 10-6 with 16:18 on the clock first half. Xavier will have the ball out of bounds.
Brian Evans is trying his best to front Williams out there.
The inbound from Gentry to Grant to Hawkins, backcourt, now to Gladden on the left wing. Gladden holds, kicks it back to Gentry, now right side to Hawkins. Hawkins fakes the three, bounces to Aaron Williams, baseline move, shot up, is around and no good. Brian Evans clears the board. Evans gives to Greg Graham. Graham brings it down across the timeline. Graham at backcourt, looks at left. Now dribbles it left side. Stops and clears it out to Brian Evans. Down low to Bailey. Damon baseline shot off the glass. No good. Rebound inside. Knocked out of bounds. It'll belong to Xavier. Hoosier fans haven't liked the officiating much thus far. And we got a timeout call. Indiana 10, Xavier 6. Here in the first half, 15:50 to go. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
If your car does this, pick up the nearest phone and do this. That's 1-800-LET-NAPA. It's your direct line to the location of the nearest NAPA store. That's where you get high-quality parts, plus the advice you need from the NAPA professionals. So when you need to hear this, just remember to do this. 1-800-LET-NAPA. NAPA, because there are no unimportant parts.
Say, neighbor, is that one of those new snapper lawn tractors I see in your garage?
You betcha. This baby is built tough, and talk about power. A Briggs IC with 12 horses, Peerless 5-speed gear drive, 30-inch cutting deck with 6 cutting heights, 32-inch turning radius, 2-year limited warranty.
Boy, you must have run into some cash to buy this snapper tractor a couple of months before the grass needs to be cut.
Oh, not at all. I just use Snap Credit, so I don't have to start paying for it until October. Besides, with snapper tractors starting at $14.99, these babies aren't going to last very long down at the snapper dealer.
You know, neighbor, I think I'll go visit that snapper dealer before the spring rush starts.
Well, here at the Hoosier Dome, we have 15 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in this first half of play, and Indiana's taking the early lead over the Xavier Musketeers 10-6. This broadcast is authorized under broadcast rights granted by the National Collegiate Athletic Association through Host Communications Incorporated, Lexington, Kentucky. It's intended solely for the entertainment of our listening audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the description or account of this broadcast without the expressed written consent of the NCAA and Host Communications is prohibited.
Well, Don, when Xavier was in their man-to-man down there, they had Steve Gentry chasing Calvert Cheney. He had no responsibility, apparently, in that defense other than just to stay with Cheney to try to keep the ball away from him. They've been fairly effective with that. When they were in the zone a moment ago, I'm not sure. We're a little bit away from them at this end of the court, so I'm not sure what they were doing with Gentry. We'll check that out. Indiana shooting 4 of 6 to start this game, while Xavier is 2 of 5. Xavier, however, out-rebounding Indiana by a 4-2 margin, and it was certainly good to see Greg Graham back on his shooting eye after going 2 of 8 the other night. He's 3 for 3 right now.
Indiana stays with the same lineup, as does Xavier's Musketeers, so nobody's made any changes just yet. Across the timeline comes Steve Gentry with a dribble. Gentry in the backcourt against Damon Bailey. Stops his move, goes left side to Brian Grant. Grant down on the left wing. Cross courts it out to Gladden. Down low to Gentry in the baseline. He'll bring it back out against Bailey. Still on the dribble, takes it inside the lane, jumps it off left side to Hawkins, or Gladden rather, who fires and misses. The rebound to Grant inside, puts it up and missed it. Aaron Williams rebounds, misses, and the ball taken out of there by Matt Nover. Nover gets it to Calvert Cheney to Damon Bailey. Bailey across the timeline in backcourt. Damon slides right, spins back to the left, gets it to Greg Graham. Graham down on the left wing against Hawkins now. He'll bring it back outside to Damon. Bailey with the ball, slides it right, comes back left to Graham. Down low to Calvert, baseline move. Calvert kicks it inside to Nover, up and in. Matt Nover scores his first 2. Beautiful feed by Cheney. The other way quickly is Gladden. Outside to Gentry, now off to Williams. Low to Brian Grant. Grant inside, shoots, misses. Rebound tapped away. Battle for it inside, and Brian Evans comes up with it, and the foul on Grant. Grant down low, bangs into Brian Evans, and the foul goes on Grant, his first of the game. First whistle on the Xavier Musketeers as a team. The Hoosiers lead 12-6 with a chance to go up even further. And coming in for the first time is Tyrus Walker, a 6'4", 190-pound junior out of Hamilton, Ohio. He'll replace Hawkins. Walker averaging 8.4 points a contest. And with the ball, as Indiana goes against a zone press now, Greg Graham brings it up. Greg gets it to Damon Bailey. Bailey back to Graham, who slides it across the timeline. Back outside to Bailey. Left side to Brian Evans on the wing. Brian starts it inside the lane, then fires a 12-footer. Missed the shot. Rebound taken out of there by Brian Grant. Down the floor it comes to Gentry. Gentry on the dribble in backcourt. Starts to move it toward the left. Comes back right, then spins with the dribble. Stops, looks inside, clears it away to Williams. Williams, backcourt, looks low, comes off to Walker on the right wing. Tyrus Walker in for the first time. Jumps it cross-court to Gladden. Gladden in the corner left, brings it back out to Gentry, now to Grant. Grant looks low, can't find anybody, dribbles it once, clears back to Gladden. Gladden now brings it out to Grant, who gets it inside to Williams, and he slams it in. Aaron Williams with his third point of the ball game got inside of Brian Evans that time and gets the easy slam. It's 12-8 now. Indiana is a 4-point leader. Against the pressure again, the Hoosiers break it across the timeline. Graham has it. Greg takes it left. Starts it to the wing. Looks, bounces low and threw it away, but it's stolen in there by Gladden, and he throws it out of bounds. So the ball tossed out of bounds by Xavier after they stole it defensively. A good play. And the Hoosiers now will get it out of bounds here on the near sideline. 12-8 score. Indiana's a 4-point leader at this point with 13:29 to go first half. Greg Graham will inbound. He looks, fires into Calvert Chaney, who goes right back to Greg. Greg Nass directing some traffic out there. Passes away to Damon Bailey. Bailey crosses the timeline. Bailey in backcourt selects what he wants to do here. Starts it right. Takes it to the wing. Brings it back out to Greg Graham. Graham goes to Calvert. Chaney on the wing. Looks in for Nover. Can't find him. Back to Graham. Graham lets another bomb fly and missed it this time. Rebound is off to Aaron Williams for Xavier. Off to Steve Jeffrey, and Jeffrey's across the timeline, takes it in the lane, kicks it off to Williams. Williams on the wing, back out to Jeffrey. Jeffrey slows, then drives it left, pulls up and fires, and he got it. Steve Jeffrey gets his first two of the ball game, and it's 12-10. Xavier just keeps hanging with you. Here's the pressure again, lightly, and Indiana breaks it as Graham crosses the timeline. Greg in backcourt, spin dribble against Gladden. Stops, goes outside to Damon Bailey, to Calvert Chaney. Slide jumper is in, no good, and the rebound batted away. And out of bounds, Tyrus Walker stepped on the line. Indiana will have it. Here comes Hawkins back in the contest now for Xavier, and Steve Jeffrey will get his first rest. So Hawkins is in, Jeffrey out, Indiana ball underneath their own hoop. Bailey will inbound, gets it to Greg Graham. Fakes, nice fade, fires a shot, good. Greg Graham has his 10th point, and he has had the hot hand for the Hoosiers. 12-21 to go first half, Indiana by four at 14-10. Backcourt dribble, Hawkins, left side it goes to Walker. Walker looks on the wing, outside to Aaron Williams. Williams turns and clears it off to Hawkins, who fires a three and got it. Michael Hawkins, his second three, his sixth point, and Indiana's lead is cut to one, 14-13. Greg Graham to Damon Bailey, back to Graham. Graham lost the handle, picks it up, fell down, traveling violation is called. Greg Graham actually tripped over Hawkins, and that's what they call the travel on. Bob Knight is up, but he'll not get any call there. And timeout is called with a score. Indiana 14, Xavier 13, 11:53 on the clock. We'll be back after the 60-second network timeout.
Oh, nice apron. Love the ruffles.
Oh, thanks. But you know, cooking with natural gas is a breeze with pilotless ignition and sealed burners. I'll cook dinner for one.
Oh, no, dear. You'll cook dinner for one.
Natural gas is what's new in today's kitchens. It's the ideal energy for cooking.
Okay, there are certain things I want to know.
Mom, look what...
Chuck Daly for Sharp.
In basketball or business.
I wish I didn't know. Now, how much do I really need to know about drying clothes?
How much money do you want to save? Natural gas is the ideal energy.
Gee, this pot roast is great. It tastes different.
Yeah, I use beef instead of bologna.
Oh, a touch of extravagance, my pet.
Eh, we can afford it now that we're cooking with gas.
Today's technology means you're cooking for less with natural gas, the ideal energy. For new information on today's natural gas technology and the ideal energy, call Indiana Gas at 1-800-777-4414.
Before we go any further, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
WNJY Joy 103, where Don Kennedy is your host for Big Band Jump. That's tonight at 6 o'clock here on Joy 103.
11:53 on the clock, first half of play. Indiana with a slim one-point lead, 14-13 over the Xavier Musketeers.
Don, one of the things that Xavier is doing an effective job of is keeping Indiana from underneath. Matt Nover has gotten loose for one under-the-basket shot. Everything else is coming from about 10 to 12 feet out, and you don't hit those quite as regularly as you do those one right underneath. Each team is 2 for 3 from three-point range. Graham has hit both, or hit the two threes, and Michael Hawkins has hit the other twos. But right now, Xavier continues to out-rebound Indiana by an 8-5 margin. Williams with three rebounds right now and a steal. Evans and Nover each have two rebounds. Indiana shooting 54%, and the Xavier Musketeers 41%.
Well, back out on the floor, Indiana sends Graham and Chaney, Evans and Nover and Bailey. So Indiana still to make a substitution in this game. Xavier's made a couple, and they have made another in the timeout period. Larry Sykes, a 6'9 sophomore, is checked into the ball game now. He replaces Aaron Williams for a moment. Here's Michael Hawkins looking for help. Bounces to Brian Grant. Back to Hawkins, who takes it in the lane, pulls up, fires, and hit it. Hawkins has got 8 points, and he's had the hot hand for Xavier. And the Musketeers have their first lead of the game, 15-14. Now Damon Bailey. Backcourt, slides it left, turns around, clears to Graham, down low pass to Calvert, lost it out of bounds. It'll belong to Xavier. Indiana struggling with some turnover problems here early. That's their fourth. Indiana now down by one. Xavier has the basketball. Looks like Xavier is trying to control the tempo of this ball game, keeping it fairly slow at least on the defensive end, doing enough pressure defensively to keep Indiana from running. Here is Hawkins. Down low pass comes inside to Grant. Turns on Bryant Evans. Missed it. Tip is no good, and the rebound comes off to Evans. Down to Damon Bailey. Across the timeline, Damon with it. Outside pass to Bryant Evans, who turns around, slurs it left to Greg Graham. Graham now on the wing, looks for Calvert, can't find him. Down low pass is for Cheney, and he is fouled by Tyrus Walker. Walker picks up his first personal. They were doing some real battling in there to get position that time, and Walker lost the battle. Indiana will have it out of bounds. Second team foul whistled on Xavier. Damon Bailey will trigger it in. The inbound comes to Calvert. Inside to Nover. Nover fakes. Left-handed lay no good. And the rebound battle for a scramble on the floor. And it is picked up by Xavier. Michael Hawkins has it. Hawkins drives left side. Lost the handle. Got it back. Stops. Looks inside. Can't find his man. Kicks it out to Gladden. Gladden drives it in the lane. Pulls up. Fires and missed the shot. Rebound. Calvert Cheney. Cheney in a double team. Gets the ball to Damon Bailey. Bailey across the timeline. Damon takes it in the lane. Scoops with the left hand. No good. Rebound battle for, and Grant's got it. Indiana miss firing now. Xavier with the ball in the lead. 15-14. This is Tyrus Walker. Bounces it outside to Sykes. Now gets it to Hawkins, who goes left to Gladden. Down low to Grant. Back to Gladden. Gladden looks inside. Kicks it out to Walker. Walker now top of the lane. Works on Bailey. Flies it away. It comes off to Hawkins. And Hawkins now fires it left wing to Gladden, who brings it on the dribble to the top of the key. Gladden backs it out, drives it right, comes back outside again. Now he goes to Walker. Walker starts it out, gives it to Hawkins. Hawkins, left side pass comes off to Gladden. Gladden brings it in the lane, gives it back to Hawkins. Three, partially blocked by Calvert, tipped away to Bryant Evans. Outside pass to Greg Graham, down the floor to Calvert. Calvert puts it up and scores! Calvert Cheney's fourth point. Indiana back on top by one at 16-15. Reynolds and Pat Graham are both getting set to check in, as is Aaron Williams and Steve Gentry for Xavier. Here's Hawkins the other way. A whistle and a foul. Damon Bailey will get charged with a personal. That'll be his first of the afternoon, and that'll be team foul number three now against IU. So three team fouls whistled on Indiana. The officials have let them play thus far. Xavier has only two team fouls. And three changes being made for Xavier here. Also coming in for the first time is Chris Mack, a 6'5 senior. Indiana has Reynolds and Pat Graham in there now as well. Steve Gentry will inbound for the Xavier Musketeers. He looks, gets it in to Mack. Mack turns around on the baseline, move, a whistle. We got a foul call against Indiana. That'll be the fourth team foul whistle on IU. And Greg Graham was the guy nailed on it. That'll be his second. So that's some trouble for Indiana, Max. He's got the 10 points so far, leading IU in scoring.
He certainly is. He's the only one hitting with any consistency right now.
The inbound pass comes in. It goes to Tyrus Walker. Walker backcourt pass to Gentry. Gentry against Reynolds. Tries to slide it right. Gentry now gives a left wing to Chris Mack. Mack brings it back on the dribble, then goes to Walker with a pass. He drives it right, fires a shot. No good. A charging foul on Walker. Yes, sir. Tyrus Walker gets nailed in his second personal. That is the third team foul now against Xavier. The Hoosiers get the ball back and have a one-point lead at 16-15. Xavier uses that full-court zone press, Max, just to slow things down, just to disrupt that flow so Indiana can't quickly get into their offense. Here's Greg Graham trying to break it this time. Gives it to the net, Matt Nover, and he threw it away. Ryan Grant stepped in the passing lane. A good job there. Here is Gentry the other way. Pulls up, fires, missed the shot, and Matt Nover's got the rebound. He goes to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds, left side to Pat Graham. Pat slows it down, turns around, looks for help, clears it finally to Calvert Cheney. Cheney holds in the wing, down low to Pat Graham. Pat can't find anybody, brings it back across the key, drives, scoop shot, blocked away, knocked away, and Steve Gentry's got it for Xavier. Indiana trying to take it inside, and they're getting beat with it. Here's Gentry down low to Grant. Grant turns, clears it back outside to Tyrus Walker. He fires a 14-footer off the rim, no, and Chris Reynolds has got the rebound. Up the floor quickly, Chris Reynolds. Right side pass taken by Calvert, out to Greg Graham. Graham fakes, gets it outside to Reynolds. Reynolds looks low, gets it into Calvert, puts it up and in. What a move! Cheney caught the ball in mid-flight, turned around in mid-air, and put it in. His sixth point of the ball game. It's now 18-15 IU. Here is Chris Mack for Xavier. Somebody lost the mouthpiece. Here's Mack on the left wing, lost the handle, got it back again. Bounces it in low to Grant. Grant turns around, looks for help, and it's finally Grant clearing it to Williams, who fires a 16-footer, no good. Rebound batted away to Pat Graham. Graham on the break to Chris Reynolds, or Greg Graham back to Pat. Scoop shot, draw to the foul. Pat Graham scores on the layup, and he's fouled in the process. 20-15 IU. The Hoosiers with a big hoop there as Todd Leary checks in for the first time. He'll replace Greg Graham. The foul call, I believe, went against Chris Mack, his first of the ball game. So a three-point play possibility here coming for Indiana's Pat Graham. And as we said, Leary has checked in. He replaces Greg Graham. As Pat Graham goes to the line, the junior out of Floyd Knobs, Indiana, looking for his third point and gets the roll. Three now for Pat Graham. Timeout is called. 7:27 left in the half. Indiana 21, Xavier 15. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
Hi, this is Willard Scott for True Value. We'd like to recognize the Indiana University basketball team, better known as the Hoosiers, for their hard work all season. It takes something really special to be a basketball player, and True Value has some impressive March specials of their own, like a Scepter 2.5-gallon polygas can with two bonus funnels. It won't rust or bend, has an easy-view level indicator, and it's just $2.99 while quantities last at your local True Value hardware store or home center.
The Hoosier Lottery reminds basketball fans that you have to play to win.
Dave the Dribbler Nelson looks for star shooter Swish Sampson for the final shot. Where is he? Oh, no, the Swishers on the sideline signing autographs. The All-Stars lose a heartbreaker all because of a 7-foot ego trip.
Get in the game and win. Play the Hoosier Lottery.
Play the two newest scratch-off games from the Hoosier Lottery. Win up to $777 with Lucky Sevens, or up to $77,000 with Super Sevens.
Here at the Hoosier Dome, it's Indiana 21, Xavier 15, 7:27 to go in this first half of play. You know, NCAA members are concerned about their communities. Through the National Youth Sports Program, NCAA member schools assist economically disadvantaged children with sports, education, and life enhancement activities. A message from the NCAA.
Well, Don, this is one of the first games since Henderson got hurt that I think Indiana really needs Henderson in there. The Xavier team really going underneath, banging in there, rebounding strong. And what Indiana needs right now is a well Allen Henderson. Knight has gone over to talk to him a couple of times, but has yet to use him. And, of course, it's questionable just how effective he might be. Here's the shooting, however. Xavier helping the Hoosiers by hitting only 6 out of 20 right now. That's just 30%. They're a ball club that'll hit 50% all season long. Indiana 9 of 17, 53%. Xavier is 0 for 7 during the last 4 minutes and 16 seconds as Indiana now has its largest lead of the afternoon, a 6-point lead.
Out of the floor, Indiana sends Calvert Cheney, Matt Nover, Todd Leary, Pat Graham, and Chris Reynolds. On the floor for the Xavier Musketeers, Brian Brandt, Aaron Williams, Michael Hawkins, Steve Jeffrey, and Jamie Gladden. So their original starting five are back in there. Across the timeline, Jeffrey for Xavier, gives it to Michael Hawkins, who takes it left wing. Down low pass to Grant, misses the shot inside, ball batted around, Williams has got it. Williams turns, had it knocked away, and we got another foul call. Personal foul called inside. Let's see on who. I think they're going to nail Nover.
Yeah.
Matt Nover gets called for his first. That's the 15th foul called on Indiana. 7:11 to go in this first half. Aaron Williams will be at the free throw line for Xavier. The Evanston, Illinois product has 3 points thus far in the game, and he's 1 for 2 from the line. 79% is shooting percentage on the season from the stripe, and he fires this one. No good. So Williams struggling just a touch from the line here this afternoon thus far. He'll have one more shot coming. Williams takes his time to look, to fire, and he missed them both. Matt Mover clears the rebound. He bounces out of trouble to Graham, out to Chris Reynolds. Down the floor come the Hoosiers. Reynolds quickly trying to penetrate, backs it back out, gives to Pat Graham, looks at right side, comes cross-court to Calvert. He lets a three-pointer fly and missed it. Rebound is pulled out of there by Aaron Williams for Xavier. Back the other way. Gentry with a basketball. Gentry inside to Grant. Grant turns, clears it back to Gentry to Gladden for a three try, and he misses it, rimmed out. Ryan Grant with a rebound long, turns around, clears it off to Gladden, down low to Hawkins. Hawkins down the wing, back out to Gladden. Gladden clears to Gentry, down low to Williams. Aaron Williams, turnaround jumper, off the glass, no. Rebound, Chris Reynolds for IU. Reynolds quickly the other way. Reynolds goes left to Calvert. Baseline 12-footer is in and out, no good. Wooden drop. Back the other way quickly comes Xavier. This is Jamie Gladden on the right wing. Gladden now on the move toward the left side, then brings it back out top of the key. Gladden sets up, gives it to Hawkins. Down low to Aaron Williams. He turns, he fires, he misses, and a foul. This time the foul is on Reynolds or Nover. We'll see. It is on Nover. So Matt has picked up his second. So Nover has two now, and that's going to bring Alan Henderson off the bench, and Henderson gets the roar from the crowd.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see how well he can perform here. If he were a healthy Henderson we saw back in January, he could really hurt, really help Indiana here.
So Alan Henderson checks into the lineup for IU. He had 4 points the other night, and his first try at playing once again as Aaron Williams drills the free throw. He's got his fourth point. So Williams with four now. He makes it 21-16. He'll try to cut the lead down to 4 points if he hits number two. And he got them both. Five now for Williams. Indiana against full court pressure. Calvert Chaney gets it off to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds motions traffic to get rid of it, drives it up the floor, gets it to Calvert. Calvert down quickly, pulls up another 15-footer, and he got it. Chaney missed a couple, but now he picks up his eighth point, and Indiana leads 23-17. Left wing dribble to Tyrus Walker. Walker bounces it in low to Grant. Grant turns on Henderson. He puts it up and missed it, and Calvert's got the rebound. Down to Leary. Quickly down the floor to Reynolds. Scoop shot, good, and a foul. Chris Reynolds scores his first two of the ball game. A big layup basket there, and he'll go to the line. The foul call on Xavier is on Aaron Williams. That's his first. So the Hoosiers get a huge bucket, and they stretch the lead to their largest margin, 25-17. They could make it a 9-point advantage if Reynolds hits the free one. Chris Ives flies and missed it badly, and the rebound comes off to Grant. Grant gives it to Gentry, or rather Gladden, and Gladden crosses the timeline to Tyrus Walker. Walker now on the right wing, takes it top of the key, looks it inside, finally clears it off to Gladden. Gladden back to Walker, right wing, he drives, baseline jump shot, in and out and in. He got the drop, and he's got his first two. 25-19. Here's Reynolds across the timeline quickly. Takes it left side to Henderson. Back out to Reynolds. Outside pass to Leary. He drives. Tries to penetrate. Gives to Chaney. Back out to Chris. Top of the lane. Now to Pat Graham. Three on the way. He got it. Pat Graham drills his sixth point on his first three try. And it's 28-19. Indiana by nine. They stretch the lead again. 4:44 and a half. Grant with the ball. Inside pass deflected. Oh, Chris Reynolds tried to jump and save it and couldn't. That was a great effort, but he just couldn't come up with a save.
His problem was he was out of bounds to start. He could have grabbed the ball, but he knew the minute he touched it, he'd be out of bounds. He tried to get back in bounds, but he couldn't make it.
Yeah, we got some people pushing and shoving out there. Williams, Reynolds, and Chaney are all there saying, let's all cool down. Hawkins will inbound for Xavier. Indiana leads 28-19. Hawkins looks for help, gets it into Aaron Williams. Williams back outside to Gladden. Jamie Gladden drives, pulls up, clears it left to Hawkins, who fires and misses. Rebound, batted out. Indiana's Calvert Chaney had it. Pat Graham picks it up. Graham out of trouble on the dribble. Pat left side to Leary. Baseline jump shot is good! Todd Leary, his first two, and Indiana leads by 11 and 4:19 to go in the half back after the 60-second network timeout.
Beaver Dam Inn in Monticello is the place for exquisite prime rib and scrumptious seafood. Visit Beavers now for their nightly dinner specials, exceptional service, and delicious homemade soups. While you're there, ask about their catering and private party services. Located just south of the Norway Dam, everyone's eager to eat at Beavers. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Call 583-8375. The Beaver Dam Inn.
Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Merkley, the affordability store, has the number one best-selling car in America. Plus, they have the number one best-selling truck in America. At Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Merkley has great selection, a pleasant atmosphere, affordable quality service, and guaranteed no high pressure. Their goal at Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Merkley is your total satisfaction. Nobody makes it more affordable than the Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury store, located at the east end of the Logan Sport Mall.
Well, the Hoosiers are on a bit of a run here as they now lead 30-19 over Xavier with 4 minutes and 19 seconds to go in this first half of play. And again, Max, it's some bench help that gets them started.
Well, and the other thing that they're doing well is scoring off the break right now. Coach Knight all along has, and his coaching philosophy is that he thinks he can score as many points off of the press as anything else, and that's happening right now as Xavier's trying to put a little pressure in Indiana scoring. The other thing that's really helping the cause is Xavier went 0 for 11 a moment ago in shooting, 6 minutes and 15 seconds without scoring from the field, and that gave Indiana an opportunity, although the Hoosiers were not all that sharp during that period of time. Rebounding continues to be Xavier's strength. They're out rebounding Indiana by 3, 18-15, but Chris Reynolds has come in there and really stirred things up since he's been in there. A couple of points, a couple of rebounds, 2 assists, and 2 steals in probably less than 4 or 5 minutes.
So Indiana right now with that 30-19 lead. The shooting has been solid. The defense has been tough inside against Xavier. And everything that the Musketeers have gotten, they've had to earn. Now, left side move is Michael Hawkins on the wing with the dribble. Stops, looks inside, trying to find Williams, can't do it. Goes out to Walker to Gladden on the right wing. Gladden, he looks low. Another new face in for the first time is Eric Edwards. He's in for Brian Grant. They threw it out of bounds. Indiana will have it. That's the 4th turnover by Xavier now. The Hoosiers have the basketball with a 30-19 lead. 3:59 to go in this first half. Here's Chris Reynolds. Up court pass to Todd Leary. Leary back to Reynolds. Reynolds gets it to Pat Graham. Inside pass goes to Calvert. Banks puts it up, scores, and a foul. Calvert Cheney. Banks over his 10th point, and he'll go to the line with another chance at a 3-point play here. Pat Graham converted a 3 the old-fashioned way earlier, and this will be the 3rd attempt at it. Chris Reynolds had the opportunity last, but he couldn't convert the free throw. But now it'll be Calvert's turn. Cheney, a 79% shooter from the line this year, looking to make this a 14-point lead, but he missed it. And the rebound comes off to Xavier. Edwards with a board. Down the floor comes to Michael Hawkins. Hawkins on the right wing against Reynolds. Hawkins looks, turns, looks, bounces to Aaron Williams, right side. Williams back out in back court. Now to Gladden. Gladden on the left wing. Stops it low into Williams. Williams tries to force it up. Does, and got it in a foul. Aaron Williams has his 7th point of the ball game. He'll have a chance at a 3-point play here. And he's had some confusion on his free throw shooting today, but he may have solved the problem hitting his last 2. Out of his first 4 attempts, he hit just 1. So now Aaron Williams will go to the line. Edwards checks out, and Brian Grant is back in now for Xavier. The Hoosiers lead at 32-21, but a chance here for Williams to knock it down to 10. 3.5 minutes left in this first half of play. Williams, the look, the shot, it's good. Williams now has converted his 8th point of the ball game. And out of the ball game goes Walker, and back in comes Steve Gentry now for Xavier. The Hoosiers basketball with 3.5 minutes left in the half. Here's Calvert Cheney to Chris Reynolds. They'll bring it up against the pressure. Off to Calvert, across the timeline, back out to Todd Leary. Now to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds starts it to the right, comes back left to Leary, down low to Pat Graham. Pat brings it out to Todd once again. Man defense being used by the Musketeers. Now Chris Reynolds has it. Reynolds lobs it cross court to Calvert. Back out to Todd. Three on the way. No good this time. Rebound, Calvert Chaney. What a great board. Good hustle. Pat Graham down low to Leary. Another three, and this time it's no good. Allen Henderson rebound. Shot up, and he couldn't get it, but he drew the foul. So Henderson will go to the line. Allen will go to the stripe, drew the foul. Looked like he might get the shot to fall, too. But it didn't. And the foul call went against Michael Hawkins, his first of the ball game. It'll be Henderson to the line with a 64% free throw shooting percentage on the season. That's not been his strong spot, but he got an offensive rebound, Max, and that has been his strong spot.
Certainly has, and you can see how important he is playing at whatever percentage it is right now that he is playing. It certainly helps. They're going to put Chaney in there to shoot.
Uh-oh. Chaney's at the line. Yeah, I don't quite get that one, but Calvert's at the stripe and gets his 11th point. I'm not sure why that happened, but nobody seems to be arguing it too much, and Calvert missed the second one. He's missed two today. He's 1 of 3. Indiana's 2 of 4 from the stripe. Indiana leads by 12. They're making 11, 33-22. Here's the pass right to Grant. Grant back out to Gladden. Gladden top of the key. Pat Graham's got him defensively. Now drives and pulls up and fires, and they're going to call a foul on Pat Graham. Pat Graham nailed to the personal. That'll be his first of the ball game. As the Hoosiers with 2.5 minutes, 2:33 to be exact, on the clock, lead by 11, but a chance here for Xavier with a clock stop to knock that lead down somewhat. Jamie Gladden goes to the line, has not scored a point yet in this ball game. He is the second leading scorer on this Xavier ball club, so they've held him in check, and he cans the first free one, his first point of the ball game. Gladden's a 72% shooter on the season from the stripe. Right now, Xavier is connected on 5 of 8 as a team. The second one is around and in. 6 of 9 now, and 2 for Gladden, and Indiana's lead cut to 9. Here's Todd Leary. Down the floor to Pat Graham. Baseline inside. Kicks it off to Henderson. Puts it up and... No, he missed the shot. That's the second easy one inside. Now, the other way, Gentry. He clears to Gladden for a 3-try. Good. Jamie Gladden's got his 5th point. That's how quickly Xavier can belt back into a ball game. 33-27. Indiana's lead cut to 6. Here is Reynolds outside to Leary. Todd in backcourt, starts it right, drives it right, pulls it back out, gives to Reynolds, who goes left to Pat Graham, who turns. Graham against Aaron Williams now, looks it low, bounces to Calvert Chaney, and he gets fouled by Gentry. So Steve Gentry picks up the personal. That'll be his first of the contest. And Calvert Chaney will once again go to the free throw line. Well, Calvert, who normally is very successful at the stripe, is just 1 of 3 so far in this ball game. Chaney with 11 points. Tell you one thing, Max, about the dome today. It's cool in here.
It really is. The wind coming in. Chaney was 4 of 6 in the game on Friday night.
Calvert hits that one, however. He's got 12 now. So Chaney now with his 12th point of the ball game will have one more shot coming. Takes the lead back up to 7, 34-27. And tries to make it an 8-point Hoosier advantage. As he eyes number 2. Up it goes, and he got it. 13 points now for Calvert Chaney, and the Hoosier lead is up to 8, 35-27. Here comes Jeffrey for Xavier. Jeffrey roared it down across the timeline, worked on by Chris Reynolds. Jeffrey starts to move it left, comes back outside to Michael Hawkins. Hawkins holds in backcourt. Xavier's offense just standing right now. Hawkins gets it back top of the key to Gladden. Gladden takes the left side on the wing. He'll bring it back out on the dribble against Todd Leary. Now he slides it to the right. Down to the baseline. Gladden looking for help. Forces one up and got it. Gladden gets his 7th point of the ball game. That was just a good offensive play on Gladden's part. Here's the inbound to Leary off to Chris Reynolds, who crosses the timeline with it on a break. Right side to Calvert. Calvert pulls up, shoots, and missed the shot. Rebound to Grant the other way. Now to Gladden, has it across the timeline for Xavier. 35-29, and Xavier with a chance to knock it down to a 4 or 3-point lead here. 58 seconds on the clock and a half. Xavier battles you all the way. Here's Gentry to Aaron Williams. Back outside to Gentry. Jeffrey now circles toward the right side. They're playing a high offense now, looking for something to break down inside. Jeffrey in backcourt. Shot clock's at 15. Game clock's at 40 seconds. Here, left side dribble is Jeffrey out to Hawkins. He tries to move, turns, clears it out to Gladden. Gladden fakes, then fires a three. No good. Rebound into Grant. Back up, he got it. Brian Grant's fourth point. 24 seconds to go in the half. The Hoosier lead is down to four. 35-31. Here's Pat Graham on the left wing. 16 seconds left in the half. Graham bounces it out to Reynolds. 12 seconds. Chris looks right, goes left, spins back to the right, goes to Pat Graham on the wing. 4 seconds left. Graham drives, kicks it to Reynolds. He fires up a bomb. It's no good. Rebound inside, and that's the end of the first half of play, and Xavier bangs their way back into it. We're at halftime at the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis, Indiana, with the Hoosiers of IU leading Xavier's Musketeers in a dogfight, 35-31. We'll be back with our halftime show in a moment. Let's pause for the 60-second network timeout.
What's clear?
New Crystal Clear Amoco Ultimate Gasoline.
What isn't?
All other premium gasolines.
What's clear?
New Improved Amoco Ultimate is the only premium refined an extra step to remove harmful impurities called PNAs.
PNAs?
Impurities that can rob your engine of performance and contribute to hydrocarbon exhaust emissions.
What's clear?
For unsurpassed performance in a cleaner environment, Crystal Clear Amoco Ultimate.
New in this area.
You expect more from a leader.
This NCAA.
Goody Sports Center is always bleeding red for the Indiana Hoosiers, and they'll bleed red for you too. Goody Sports Center, located in downtown Monticello, is your total sporting goods headquarters, even if your favorite colors aren't red and white. If it has anything to do with sports, Goody's has it. Whether it's shoes, sweats, jackets, or any kind of sports equipment, you can get it at Goody Sports Center. Goody, located in the Shoppers Concourse, 103 South Main in downtown Monticello. Call 583-3009.
We're back watching into the Hoosier Dome. We are at halftime here as Indiana leads Xavier 35-31, but it wasn't too long ago the Hoosiers owned a 12-point lead. In fact, I think it was a 13 at one time. But Xavier battles their way right back into it, and they're down by just 4 at the break. And so that gives, of course, Bob Knight ammunition for the locker room at the halftime, as the Hoosiers right now lead by just 4. Let's look at the individual scoring in this first half. First of all, for the Musketeers of Pete Gillen, Steve Gentry fired in 1 field goal for 2 points and a personal foul. Jamie Gladden has a pair of field goals, one of those a 3-pointer, along with 2 free throws for 7 first half points and no fouls. Brian Grant has a pair of field goals for 4 points and 1 foul. Aaron Williams popped home 2 field goals in the first half to go along with 4 free throws, and he has 8 first half points with 1 personal foul. Michael Hawkins, 3 field goals, 2 of those were 3-pointers, 8 first half points and 1 foul. Tyrus Walker with a field goal for 2 points and 2 personals. Chris Mack played, picked up 1 foul. Larry Sykes and Eric Edwards both played, did not score or foul. So the top scorers right now for Xavier are Aaron Williams and Michael Hawkins, who will pop for 8 apiece. In the first half for IU, it was Chris Reynolds with a field goal for 2 points, no fouls. Damon Bailey did not score, picked up 1 personal. Calvert Cheney fired home 5 field goals, 3 free throws, 13 first half points, and picked up 1 foul. Greg Graham, 4 field goals for Graham, but he sat much of the first half because of a couple of personal fouls. 2 of Greg's field goals were 3-pointers, so he has 10 first half points and 2 fouls. Bryant Evans started, did not pick up a foul, nor did he score. And Pat Graham has came in relief with a couple of field goals, 1 a 3-pointer and a free throw, 6 first half points, 1 personal foul. Todd Leary also in relief, a field goal this afternoon for 2 points and no fouls. So right now, the Hoosiers have 2 players in double figures. Calvert Cheney and Greg Graham have done most of the scoring. 13 for Cheney, 10 for Graham. Max, look at those team stats.
Neither team shooting 50% here in this first half. Indiana has dropped now to 14 of 30 for 46.7. That's after having a high in the upper 50s for a while as they started things off. The only thing that's helping the Hoosiers right now is that Xavier is shooting even worse. They are 11 of 31, 35%. They've had lots of opportunities right out in front because they have been rebounding and getting some offensive boards, but they have not been able to convert. From three-point range, both teams 3 of 7, 42.9. Free throws, Indiana 4 of 7, 57%. Xavier 6 of 9, 67%. Rebounding, Indiana being out-rebounded by a 24-18 margin, with Williams and Grant having about 15 of those 24 rebounds. So they have done an excellent job in there. Indiana has been able to come off the bench with 10 points, including 6 rebounds, 4 assists, and a couple of steals. Pat Graham with 6, Todd with 2, and Chris with 2. In the final 9 minutes and 9 seconds of play, Indiana was 8 of 19, 427. That came after a start of 625, so they hit really well to start, but finished rather poorly in the shooting. Cheney is 5 of 9. Alan Henderson has missed both shots he's taken. Matt Nover is 1 for 2. Greg Graham 4 for 5. Damon Bailey has yet to score. He's 0 for 3. Reynolds is 1 for 2. Leary is 1 for 3. Pat Graham 2 for 3. Brian Evans missed his only shot. Hawkins is 3 of 6. Aaron Williams, who hits 55%, is 2 for 7 in this game, as is Brian Grant in this first half, 2 for 7. He hits 66% from the field. So you can see they are struggling in their shooting. In the had a 13-point lead at 32-19, their largest lead. The score, the lead has changed one time since the Xavier team had a 1-point lead at 15-14. Other than that, Indiana has led all the way by, like we said, by as much as 13, but right now it's down to 4.
Well, each year the NCAA awards more than $1 million in scholarships through its honors program, ethnic minority and women's enhancement programs, and postgraduate study grants as well. For more information, you can contact the NCAA National Office. A message from the NCAA. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
WNJY, Delphi, Monticello, where Machine Gun Kelly is your host for New Gold on CD. That's weekdays right before 11:30 and again just before 5 o'clock here on Joy 103.
And we'll be back with more of our halftime show here in a moment. But first, let's pause for the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
A law firm that believes integrity comes first. O'Brien and Morrissey wants you to know about their law practice located at 1015 Bank One Building in Lafayette. You can talk to Thomas O'Brien or Michael Morrissey with your first consultation free. They can assist you in divorce, personal injury, real estate, wills, estates, drunk driving, and criminal cases. Meeting the legal needs of the people in our area, O'Brien and Morrissey. Call 317-742-9027.
Chevy's, Logan Sports' most popular nightclub, invites you to rock and roll to the greatest hits of the 50s and 60s every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. Yes, Chevy's friendly atmosphere, unbelievable lighting, and outstanding sound makes for a good time for everyone. Now at Chevy's on Sunday night, it's country western night. So pull on the boots, get out the hat, and plan to dance the two-step at Chevy's. Whether you're looking for a little bit of country or a little bit of rock and roll, Chevy's has it. Located inside Meyer's Sport Bowl East, 1/2 mile east of the Logan Sport Mall.
Back here again at the Hoosier Dome, Indiana leading the Xavier Musketeers 35-31 at halftime. Mike Lopresti, follows national basketball as well as Indiana, I'm sure, but who spent a couple of days this weekend in Chicago watching the other part of this Midwest regional. And before we get to Chicago, Mike, your thoughts on this first game?
Well, Max, I mean, Xavier has done just what it intended to do. Get the ball down. They have some great inside people. Get the ball inside. Try to get some foul trouble. And it's worked to a certain degree. Now, that's a team used to shooting the ball very well, and they had some problems that first half. I think part of that's a credit to Indiana defense. But Xavier has executed its game plan, and Indiana's had to respond a little bit to that. And that's why we have a good ball game at halftime.
Down at the other end of the court, Xavier's done a fair job of keeping away from Indiana away from some of those rather easy shots they often get in games.
Yeah, they clog the middle, and they've handled defensive boards. This is a good basketball team. It's well coached, and I think the Hoosiers expected this coming in. They were going to have to play well.
Well, what do you think about this section of the Midwest so far? It's gone pretty much according to the seeds at any rate.
Well, I think so. I think, you know, obviously in this building, Indiana's going to be tough to catch. And with Louisville as well there, it's, as you mentioned, I was in Chicago last night, and that was a heck of a game, and certainly that was a surprise.
Mike, I want to come back and talk about the particular Duke game I'm sure you're referring to, but right now we need to pause 60 seconds. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Professional interiors. What does that mean? Well, according to Funk and Wagnall, professional means skilled in a profession, art, or craft. Interior means pertaining to the inside. Now, what it doesn't mean is expensive. At Professional Interiors, you'll find the best prices on the best brands of carpet anywhere. So don't be surprised if you find that high-quality carpet that you saw elsewhere and thought you couldn't afford priced so low that you'll wonder how the other guy sells any of it. Professional Interiors, 570 South Main Street in Monticello. The best carpet and best prices.
McGreevy's Pizza King, a place where your lunch hour is your time. Come in, sit down and relax. Choose from a large selection of super sandwiches, delicious salads, and sensational soups. Let them bring the food to you. McGreevy's Pizza King wants you to enjoy your lunch hour. For your next lunch break, enjoy McGreevy's Pizza King on the square in Delphi. McGreevy's Pizza King, more than just great pizza.
The Indiana Hoosiers lead the Xavier Musketeers at halftime, 35-31 here in the Hoosier Dome, and we're talking to Mike Lopresti, who covers basketball as well as all other sports, that matter, for Gannett. And Mike, you were in Chicago, you were talking about the Duke game. What were your thoughts on that?
Well, you know, a lot of people said it's good to have a new champion. You know, Duke's been there for so long, but I've never seen a team work any harder to survive than Duke had to last night. Cal played very well. All of a sudden, you look up, there's 13 minutes left in the game. Cal's ahead 17. And after one free throw, Hurley got the team together at the free throw line, and you could just see him willing them on to one last charge. And they made it, and I really thought when Duke got the lead there that they had the game. But I think at one stretch I figured out when Duke got within one, they missed six straight shots with a chance to get the lead. And I think that gave Cal a chance to sort of regroup for the last stretch run. But heck of an effort by Duke, particularly the older kids. And I felt a little sorry for him after the game. The post-game press conference, Mike Krzyzewski was truly touched that it was his last game with Bobby Hurley and Thomas Hill.
Well, they've been quite a dynasty there for a while, and I'm sure they're not going to go away forever, but at least it's not going to be this year. What about Cal? Are they for real, or are they just getting themselves all excited here for some reason?
Well, you know, they're playing on a little bit of emotion. They have that they're perceived that they're unrespected, but I'll tell you what, there's a lot of talent on that team, and Jason Kidd is a type of player you don't see very often with his court awareness, I think, is what he does best. I'm sure a lot of people have been watching those games on TV, and his ability to find the open man without looking, to choreograph the game of basketball on the court. I think I see a little touch of Bird and Johnson and Magic going back to that year in 79 when they could do so much with the ball with their teammates. And you see a lot of that with Jason Kidd. But they have a lot of other talented young kids. I tell you what, Cal's making a heck of a run this year. And if those kids stay together and keep going the right direction, there's a power for years to come.
Mike, we got about a minute here. We've had a lot of upsets. What are your predictions now?
Well, I think still you have to look at those number one seeds that have really looked solid. When you look at Indiana and North Carolina and Kentucky and Michigan, once you get past that, a lot of people have been vulnerable. But I think until one of those four teams is caught, I still look at those four to decide one way or the other. But obviously we're getting into this second round, and teams like Indiana are going to have some tough games. This is going to be a tough ball game today, obviously, to the end.
Well, if you get those four in there, who's your pick?
I think Michigan, when it is right, is the most talented team. But I'll tell you what, North Carolina, I've seen them play three times the last month. They are on a roll. I suppose if I had to pick a team, it'd be North Carolina. But I'd take any of the four and feel like I had a real good shot.
Well, here in the second half, Indiana certainly had his work cut out for it. 4 points are not very money against Xavier.
No, it's going to go back to whether Indiana can keep the defensive intensity. And fouls obviously are going to be a factor. Xavier's going to continue to bang the ball inside. If they get a couple of the Indiana kids inside in foul trouble, this is going to be a close game.
Mike, I appreciate your stopping by. I'll give you a couple of minutes here. You can go get yourself a Coke, and we'll get ready for the second half.
Thanks a lot, man.
All right, Mike Lopresti talking with us here at halftime. The official stats have been presented to us, and officially it's Xavier 11 of 31, 35% shooting in the first half. They're better than that, so Indiana, I'm sure Xavier feels pretty good being down by only 4 points and just 35% shooting. Indiana, on the other hand, 14 of 30, 46%, and that's down for them, and they've been really hot lately in tournament play or in the last few games during this season. They have shot very well. As a matter of fact, their 57% was their fifth consecutive game in which they've shot 50% or better. During that span, they really have shot 58% from the field during the last five games and 50% in seven of their eight last games. So this first half shooting is a little bit off for them also, but nevertheless, they are shooting a better percentage than is Xavier in this basketball game. Foul shooting a little bit off for Indiana, just 4 of 7. I think they hit the first 10 they shot in their first game against Wright State, and Xavier is 6 of 9 so far. We have one score to report out of the East. Virginia has taken a 36-19 lead. Is that a halftime score? It is at the halftime. 36-19. So that's a bit more of an upset to start with, but a bit more even than you would think. That's a pretty sizable margin there to have at the half in that particular game. But here it is, 35-31, Indiana up by 4.
We'll be back with the start of the second half right after we pause for the 60-second network timeout.
I nestled into booth 12 at Waffle House when I heard that...
May I help you?
...voice. There stood the most pleasant, caring...
Nice haircut.
...person I'd ever met. Over the next hour, we shared...
I recommend...
...many thoughts.
Coffee.
...about life. You see, I had reached...
Dessert? Fishing tips?
The service zone.
If we could be open more than day and night, we would. We're more than lip service. We're Waffle House.
I moved to booth 11. Oh, miss...
Hi, this is Willard Scott for True Value. We'd like to recognize the Indiana University basketball team, better known as the Hoosiers, for their hard work all season. When your team is on a roll, it usually means they're doing well. To get on a roll when you take out the garbage, all you need is the Roughneck 32-gallon wheel trash container from Rubbermaid. It offers a locking lid and a manufacturer's 6-year warranty, and it's just $9.77 at your local True Value hardware store or home center.
Well, back once again to the Hoosier Dome as we get set to start the second half of this ball game. Indiana with a 4-point lead at 35-31. Indiana on the floor with Greg Graham, Chris Reynolds, Damon Bailey, Matt Nover, and Calvert Cheney. Xavier goes with Gentry, Hawkins, Williams, Grant, and Gladden. Their original starting five. Here we go. Hawkins with the basketball in backcourt, takes it to the left wing. Xavier with the ball to start the second half. Now to Grant, right side to Gentry. Gentry on the wing. Back out to Hawkins. Hawkins slides it left to Grant, who fires a jumper. Got it. Brian Grant, Kansas' 6th point of the ball game, and suddenly Xavier's within two. 35-33. Reynolds, backcourt dribble. Chris looks, turns, clears it left side, goes to Bailey. Bailey brings it back out. Damon starts it to the wing. Bailey now looks low, comes outside to Reynolds. Reynolds can't find anybody, goes back left to Bailey, who fires the jump shot. Going! Damon's first two of the ball game. Indiana's on top, 37-33. Xavier's Jeffrey to Williams, right side to Hawkins. On the wing, lobs a low to Grant, turns, clears back to Hawkins, outside to Gladden. Gladden now into Williams. Turnaround jump shot is up and in. Aaron Williams scores. He's got 10. Xavier starts out tough inside of the second half of play. It's 37-35. Bailey with the basketball. Damon top of the key. Left side pass goes to Greg Graham. Back out it comes to Chris Reynolds. Now off the cover. Cheney looks low for Nover. Can't find him. Goes back to Reynolds. Reynolds down to Damon Bailey on the right wing. Damon holds on Williams. Drives on him. Brings it back out top of the key. Damon turns it around. Looks for help now as he looks inside. Can't find Nover. Here's Damon on the dribble still to the left. Goes down on the wing. It comes to Calvert. He drives the baseline. Pulls up and couldn't get the roll. Tip up is good by Nover. Nover's 4th point of the ball game. 39-35. Again, the Hoosiers by 4. Gladden backcourt to Gentry. Now to Williams. Lobs low to Grant inside. Grant lost the handle but got it back. Outside to Williams. In left wing to Hawkins. Down low to Grant. Turns on Nover. Back out it comes to Gentry. A three or a long jumper on the way. No good. Rebound tipped up to Grant. He got it. Ryan Grant with his eighth point, and credit Aaron Williams for keeping that ball alive on the board. 39-37. Dogfight again. Here's Greg Graham toward the left side of the circle. Out to Chris Reynolds. Takes it in the lane. Pulls up. Gives to Nover. Matt back outside. It goes to Bailey. Damon penetrates. Lost the handle. Whistle. We got a foul on Hawkins. Michael Hawkins picks up personal number two. So the Hoosiers will have it out of bounds. Indiana underneath their own hoop, leading by 239-37, 17-39 on the clock, just underway in the second half. Bailey inbounds to Calvert. Calvert turns around, lost the handle. Steal as Xavier goes down the floor. This is Jamie Gladden on the left wing. Gladden outside to Jeffrey, now up to Hawkins. He fakes, drives it into Gladden. Gladden fires the long bomb. It's no good. Rebound. Calvert fights for it. They can't save it. Grant's got it. Grant gets it out to Gladden. Another long one is good. Gladden gets the two-pointer, his ninth point. We're tied at 39. The Musketeers are in the hunt. Here's Chris Reynolds to Matt Nover. Back out to Bailey. Damon clears it left wing. It goes to Greg Graham. Graham slides it out to Reynolds. Reynolds turns and clears to Bailey. Almost threw it away. Damon down low to Nover inside. He fires it up and got it. Matt Nover powers his way for his sixth point. 41-39, the Hoosiers. Here is Gladden on the other side, right wing. Holds, looks, fires it out to Gentry. Down low, pass goes to Grant. Now way to Hawkins for a three try. No good. Rebound inside, knocked out of bounds, Indiana ball. Tell you what, Max, they are battling on the front line.
With this lineup, both teams are at a little bit of a disadvantage. They don't match up that well. Williams is trying to guard Bailey, for instance, and Bailey, of course, takes him way out on the front. But then on the other, to get the other end of the court, then there's nobody big down there to help out Nover and Cheney.
Larry Sykes has checked in to replace Brian Grant. Here come the Hoosiers. Chris Reynolds on the dribble. Backcourt moves, stops, down low to Calvert, baseline. Cheney tries to drive and a foul on Jeffrey. Steve Gentry gets called for his second personal. And Indiana will get the ball out of bounds. A lot of hanging on going on in Calvert right now as he's moving hard out there. David Bailey will trigger it in.
Xavier still rebounding strongly, 26-20 over Indiana.
Inbounding will be Bailey, looks it in. Backcourt pass to Reynolds. Chris drives it, left side of the lane, spins, whistle, another foul. So all of a sudden, the Hoosiers are doing a lot more driving the basket backs, and there's a lot more reaching going on by the Musketeers.
Yeah, it's a complete change. Indiana got the early fouls in that first half of play, and now Xavier has picked up three real quick here at the start of the second half.
However, Gladden's first personal, and this will send Chris Reynolds to the free throw line. Indiana by two. Reynolds 0-for-1 in this ball game, and now, no, he couldn't get the roll. He'll have one more shot coming. That's something the Hoosiers have not done well in this game. Shot free throws. They're 4 of 8. He'll try to make it a three-point Indiana lead if he can convert number two. It is no good. Tipped up. And Aaron Williams has got it for the Musketeers. So the Xavier Musketeers down two with the ball. Gentry. Backcourt move against Reynolds. Bounce pass almost thrown away, but Hawkins retrieves it. Back off to Jamie Gladden. Gladden against Greg Graham. Gladden now. Pulling it back outside. Now drives it to the left side. Down toward the baseline. Pulls up. Bounce pass to Hawkins. He fakes the jumper. Down low to Williams. Turnaround jump shot is in the air. No good. Rebound batted up. Pulled out of there by Calvert Cheney. Off to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds out to Bailey. Damon crosses the lane. Bounces to Calvert. Cheney on the wing. Holds it and gives it back to Bailey. He tries to get it in and over. And there's a foul call. This will be Aaron Williams. That's his second of the ball game, and that's the 14th foul whistle on Xavier with time being called. Indiana 41, Xavier 39, 15:42 to go in this final half of play. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
In the Hoosier State. State Farm is helping Indiana families with the free family insurance checkup. A State Farm agent is there to help you keep your car, home, life, and health insurance up to date, so the coverage you need will be there when you need it, wherever you live, from South Bend to Evansville. Check your phone book. Get your free family insurance checkup now. And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Madame Yolanda will read your palm. Oh, you're a farmer. You grow beans.
Soybeans.
I feel a powerful presence. Two strong forces working together to solve all your problems.
Could it be tricept herbicide?
Are your problems broadleaf weeds and grasses?
Yes.
Like pigweeds, foxtails, cockleburr?
Yeah.
Ah, then the answer is tricept, made with Scepter herbicide and Treflan herbicide for the most power you can pack in a jug.
All that's in my palm?
No, in your tricept brochure. Oh, one more thing. See your Cyanamid AgriCenter dealer. Read and follow label directions.
Here the Hoosier Dome, Don Fisher along with Max Skirvin. Second half, 15:42 to go, and Indiana with a slim 41-39 lead over Xavier.
Well, Don Joe Smith just points out, the last time Indiana played here in the Dome, they played Kansas and were 4-for-13 foul shooting. And as you pointed out, we're now 4-of-9 in this game. I don't know whether it's the look up here on foul shooting in this building that caused the problem or not, but Indiana has not done well as far as the foul shooting is concerned, at least in this season here in the Hoosier Dome. Indiana rebounding even with Xavier practically this half, 4-to-5. Xavier with a one-point edge, a run rebound edge. They're 27-22 overall. Indiana is 3-for-4 in this half shooting. Xavier is 4-for-8.
Well, Indiana was 15-20 yesterday or Friday from the line, so it can't all be that, but certainly you hate to see them struggling with that free throw shooting that they had struggled with earlier in the season.
Well, they were 10-for-10, let's see, so they were 5 for their second 10 and now 4-for-13, so that's 9-for-23 since they hit the first 10 they took in that game.
Brian Grant has checked back in now, and Aaron Williams gets a blow for Xavier. Damon Bailey will inbound to Greg Graham for IU, puts it up and scores! Greg Graham with a nice shot there for his 12th point of the ball game. Nice turn inside, 43-39, Indiana by 4 again. Gentry backs it out on the dribble. Starts to slide it right. Hoosier fans are starting to get into it. Now bounce low to Graham, puts it up, he misses. Rebound taken out of there by Nover. Nover clears it away to Graham. Down the floor to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds on the right side. Looks in, bounces to Calvert. Chaney bounces back to Chris. Chris holds onto it. Top of the key, goes left side to Greg Graham. Graham on the wing, looks for some help. A whistle away from the ball. We got a foul call. Foul against Xavier. Gentry, I believe. We'll wait and see. It was Gentry. That's his third personal. So Indiana will have it out of bounds. Damon Bailey will trigger it in. Bailey looks. Backcourt pass to Reynolds. Reynolds now flies it to Calvert Chaney. Chaney on the wing. Back to Reynolds. Stops, looks, gets it into Calvert, fires the shot up. Good! Calvert Chaney, he's got 15. Indiana leads 45-39. Here's Gentry in the backcourt move, drives it right side, clears it away to Gladden. A long three is no good. Rebound fought for, a whistle. What do we got? Foul call is on Xavier. Larry Sykes gets nailed in his second personal foul. The Hoosiers get the basketball back, and I think we got a timeout call or what? Pete Gillen's out on the floor asking something, but a time has been called with a score. Indiana 45, Xavier 39. We'll be back after the 60-second network timeout.
The Hoosier Lottery reminds basketball fans that you have to play to win.
Dave the Dribbler Nelson looks for star shooter Swiss Sampson for the final shot. Where is he? Oh, no, the Swisters on the sideline signing autographs. The All-Stars lose a heartbreaker all because of a 7-foot ego trip.
Get in the game and win. Play the Hoosier Lottery.
Play the two newest scratch-off games from the Hoosier Lottery. Win up to $777 with Lucky Sevens or up to $77,000 with Super Sevens.
Selling here, buying there? The Century 21 VIP referral network is there to ease the worry. Relocating can be a frustrating experience. That's why you need the Century 21 VIP referral network. As the largest real estate organization in the world, they offer trained specialists ready to sell your current home, find your next, and ease all of the headaches in between. Thinking about moving? Call your local Century 21 office today or call 1-800-886-4849. Each office independently owned and operated.
Well, back once again at the Hoosier Dome. Well, Indiana has jumped to a six-point lead at 45-39 and will have the ball. Dean Ash, Gentlemen's and Ladies Clothier of Indianapolis, want to join the thousands of Hoosier fans all across the state in congratulating Indiana University's basketball team on winning the Big Ten Championship. And, of course, wishing them all the best in their quest for the 93 NCAA title. D-Nads is open daily Monday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. and on Wednesday and Thursday till 9. That's D-Nads Clothing to complement your lifestyle on West 86th Street at Township Line Road in the North Willow Mall in Indianapolis.
Xavier continues to shoot poorly, just 4 of 10, 40%. They shot only 35% in the first half. A lot of that is due to Indiana defense, but they've also just missed some shots that they normally would put in. Indiana very effective in this half. They've hit 5 out of 6.
Full court pressure will be applied by the Musketeers. Damon Bailey will inbound. It'll be that semi-full court press. They pretty much a zone press is what they do, and they start picking you up after the first or second pass just so that you cannot take the ball quickly down the floor. It's primarily used to disrupt your offensive quickness at the outset. Make you lose a little bit of clock just to get it up the floor. The bounce pass to Reynolds. Jumps it left side to Gray Graham. Graham on the wing. Back out it comes to Bailey. Now to Reynolds. Now up to Bailey again to Reynolds in backcourt. Reynolds slides it to the right. Reynolds spins it out to Bailey. Bailey holds high. Looks it in. Comes back left side. It goes to Graham again. Greg outside to Chris Reynolds. He tries to penetrate. Down low he goes. Scoops it up. No good. Rebound comes off to Aaron Williams. Williams gives it off to Walker. Walker bounces it away to Gladden, and Gladden crosses the timeline for Xavier. Gladden in backcourt. On the dribble, setting up the offense, takes it to the left side. They're working a very high offense right now, trying to get something to break free underneath. Again, Gladden circles to the right. He's on the wing. Back out to Michael Hawkins. Hawkins now. Spins on Reynolds, drives it toward the left, takes it down to the left wing. Hawkins backs it out again. They're simply using clock now. Here's Hawkins, a whistle. 5-second call. 5-second call against Xavier. And that got Todd Leary off the bench waving the towel. And the Hoosiers got it on the turnover. 45-39 IU. They didn't take advantage of the last opportunity. The Hoosiers would like to make it an 8-point lead here. The lob goes to Reynolds. Across the timeline he comes. Bounces back to Damon. Bailey holds in backcourt. Gives it to Reynolds. Right side to Matt Nover. Nover doesn't take the shot. Back to Chris. Now left side to Graham. Graham tries to work on the wing. Brings it back outside to Bailey. Bailey now slides in on the left side as well. Bounces low to Nover. Inside the ball stripped away and Aaron Williams steals it. Good defensive play by the Musketeers. Back the other way comes Gladden. Gladden goes right to Williams on the baseline. Lazlo to Grant inside. Batted away by Cheney. The steal to Bailey. Bailey down the floor in a hurry. Takes it all the way. Scoops and misses, but a foul. So Damon Bailey will go to the line for a couple. I think Hawkins might have gotten nailed on this personal. It is Michael Hawkins. That is his third foul of the ball game. That's the 17th foul against Xavier. The Hoosiers haven't been called for a foul in the second half. 13:01 to go in this ballgame.
Don, one of the things now that's happened is Hawkins has three and Gentry has three. They are the two people that Pete Gillen has assigned to Cheney to just shadow him all over the court.
Damon Bailey fires it, no good. Bailey has just 2 points in the ballgame. He'll get one more shot coming here, and Indiana's free throw shooting struggle has continued in this ballgame. One more shot coming to Bailey. He'll try to make it a 7-point lead, and he does. Bailey has got three of the Hoosiers' lead at 46-39. Xavier on the attack again. Steve Gentry's back in, and he's got the ball. Gentry to the right side move, baseline pull up, and he missed the shot inside. The rebound batted up, and Calvert Cheney pulls it down. Cheney to Reynolds. Reynolds down the floor quickly. Gets it away to Greg Graham. Down to Bailey on the baseline. Damon looks inside. Gets it to Calvert. Calvert underneath. Puts it up. Reverse layup is no good. Rebound batted away and Greg Graham came out with it. He gives it to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds back to Graham. Graham sets up the offense now. Greg starts it left. Spins back right. Down to the right side of the circle. Still moving with the ball. Gives the ball off to Chris Reynolds into Calvert, puts it up and missed it. Tip up is no good. Tip again, no. Tip up again, no. Tip up again. And Williams has got it for Xavier. Back to Gentry. Here come the Musketeers. Indiana struggling to get it to fall all of a sudden. Down low, Brian Grant. Turns around, clears back to Hawkins. Now to Gladden for a three try, and he got it. Jamie Gladden has got his 12th point. That's a big three for Xavier. They trail by just four. 46-42. Bob Knight said it's going to be a 40-point game, boys, and boy, it has been that thus far. Reynolds, left side pass comes off to Bailey, a three try, no good. Rebound to Brian Grant. Back the other way. Here is Gentry, backcourt move, top of the key, looks left, gives the basketball off to Gladden. Gladden bounces the ball to Hawkins. Hawkins now looks inside, gets it into Aaron Williams. His jump shot is off the mark, no. Rebound, Matt Nover pulls it out for IU. That was a big defensive play there for IU. Here comes Bailey. Across the timeline, Damon takes it to the right wing, drives it all the way, pulls up, shoots, and scores! Damon Bailey, his fifth point of the ball game, a big driving shot there. It's 48-42, and Indiana's lead back up to six. Brian Evans, Pat Graham, and Todd Leary are all getting set to check in for the Hoosiers. Here is Gentry. Left side pass goes to Gladden. Gladden pulls up on the left wing. Gladden holds, looks inside, drives it out, pulls up and fires it back inside, threw it away. Greg Graham comes up with it. Graham down the floor, drives it up, pulls up, scores, yes! Greg Graham, 14th point, and he drew the foul. Indiana 50, Xavier 42, and IU could be up by nine if he cans the free one. Nover sits down. So does Chris Reynolds and Damon Bailey. But Greg Graham and Calvert Cheney will stay on the floor with Evans, Pat Graham, and Todd Leary. And Greg will go to the free throw line and a chance at a big three-point play.
Cheney has played every minute of this game. He played the entire 20 minutes of the first half. He's been in their entire second half. That's the third foul on Williams, and now the Xavier team has three players, Gentry, Williams, and Malkins, all with three fouls.
Greg Graham fires the free one, good. And Greg Graham now has his 15th point. Indiana 51, Xavier 42. The Hoosier crowd wants IU to start putting the Musketeers away. I'm not sure you can get that done. Here is Walker, right side to Gladden. Gladden back out to Walker. Walker, one dribble, back to Gladden on the right wing. He lets a three fly and got it. Jamie Gladden cans a big three-pointer there, his 15th point of the ball game. Give the Muskies credit, they are a fighting ball club. It's 51-45. Here's a drive by Leary, back outside to Pat Graham. Now right to Brian Evans. Evans to Leary. Leary, down low to Pat Graham on the wing. Pat looks in, then fires the jump shot and got it. Pat Graham scores his 8th point. Indiana 53, Xavier 45, the lead back up to 8. Left side, here's Gladden on a drive. Inside, puts it up, missed the shot, tip up, no. Aaron Williams tips it in. Williams gets his 12th point. Now down the floor, Indiana's Greg Graham. To Pat Graham in backcourt. Pat drives it to the left, on the wing, pulls up. Trying to find Greg Graham, couldn't get it done, fires it out to Brian Evans. Back to Pat Graham, left side to Greg Graham. Greg now moves it, drives baseline, spins, puts it up, and scores! Greg Graham, 17th point. Indiana, 455, Xavier, 47. What a great driving shot that was. Here is Gladden on the right side of the circle, outside to Walker. Walker, top of the key. Gets it out to Gentry. Gentry backs it out on the dribble. They slow it down. Greg Graham holding his left or his right shoulder there. Now, Gentry walks it, starts it to the right, comes back left, goes right again, moves it to the wing. Now holds, looks it inside, gets it to Grant in the baseline. Brian Grant crosses out to Walker. He drives, he fires it inside, the ball batted away, scramble four, and it's going to belong to Xavier. And we're going to have a timeout, or are we? Nope, they're just going to make a change as Sykes comes in for Brian Grant now. So Larry Sykes for Grant. Inbounding will be Steve Gentry. Gentry looks. Shot clock's down to five. Gladden fires it up quickly. A whistle. What do we got? They call a foul, I think, on Pat Graham. Pat Graham gets nailed on the personal. That's his second of the ball game, and only the first foul called in Indiana here in the second half. 8 minutes, 44 seconds to go, and the Hoosiers backs get their first personal.
Well, that was a big one, too, because Gladden's shot was off. It was not much of a foul, but nevertheless, Indiana had a chance to bring it back down court again.
Well, Gladden has been a thorn. He fires this free one, and he does not convert it. Jamie Gladden has 15 points in this game. He's connected on three threes, and now he is 2 of 3 from the line. One more shot coming. This one is good. Gladden now has 16 points. Indiana's lead cut down to 7, 55-48. Gladden goes to the sideline for a rest. Sykes, Gentry, Walker, Hawkins in the ball game along with Aaron Williams. Here's Todd Leary bringing it up for IU against the press. Leary across the timeline. Todd in backcourt. Gives it to Pat Graham. Graham looks for Calvert. Can't find him. Goes to Brian Evans. Evans pulls up. Back out it comes to Pat. Pat turns around. Looks. Then fires a 15-footer and got it. Pat Graham's got 10. Two big baskets by Pat. And it's 57-48. The lead back up to 9. Gentry. Backcourt dribble. Directs traffic. Flies the ball away to Walker. He drives it to the baseline. Then fires his own 8-footer and he got it. Tyrus Walker's got his 4th point. Now it's 57-50. Here's Pat Graham the other way. Gives it to Greg Graham. Greg circles it backcourt to Bryant Evans, who lets it fly and didn't get the roll. The rebound comes off to Xavier. Down the floor, this is Gentry. Gentry on the right wing. Lobs it low to Aaron Williams. Inside, Williams puts it up and got it in the foul. Aaron Williams scores his 14th point and will have a chance at a 3-point play here. 57-52. Brian Evans makes a mistake down low, and at the other end, he shoots one maybe too quickly, and he'll come to the sideline as Matt Milver checks in for him.
15 seconds. In for Xavier.
So going to the stripe will be Aaron Williams at a 3-point play possibility.
Xavier now shooting 50%. That's the first time in this half or even in the game they've shot 50% at any given period.
Williams at the line. Fires it up good, and he's got the lead back down to 4 again. That's 15 for Aaron Williams. We got a timeout, and the score is Indiana 57, Xavier 53, with 7:45 to go. It's still a ball game and anybody's contest to take home. We'll be back after the 60-second network timeout.
Say, neighbors, that one of those new snapper lawn tractors I see in your garage?
You betcha. This baby is built tough. And talk about power. A Briggs IC with 12 horses, Peerless 5-speed gear drive, 30-inch cutting deck with 6 cutting heights, 32-inch turning radius, 2-year limited warranty.
Boy, you must have run into some cash to buy this snapper tractor a couple of months before the grass needs to be cut.
Oh, not at all. I just use Snap Credit, so I don't have to start paying for it until October. Besides, with snapper tractors starting at $14.99, these babies aren't going to last very long down at the snapper dealer.
You know, neighbor, I think I'll go visit that snapper dealer before the spring rush starts.
This is the sound of a car broken down on the side of the road. The driver is thumbing his way to the nearest Napa Auto Parts store. Too bad he didn't think about that sooner. You see, we carry over 125,000 different parts. So if anybody can help him get back on the road fast, it's Napa. Napa, because there are no unimportant parts.
Well, back once again at the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis. It's Indiana leading slimly, 57-53 over the Xavier Musketeers. You know, ticket applications are now available for the 1994 NCAA Final Four, scheduled for April 2nd and 4th in Charlotte, North Carolina. To receive an official form, write to 1994 Final Four Tickets, 6201 College Boulevard, Overland Park, Kansas, 66211-2422. Completed applications must be received by April 30th, 1993.
Season radios for cars and light trucks.
Indiana continues to shoot well, 10 of 16 this half, 62%, but Xavier now beginning to warm up, 9 of 18, 50% after a terrible first half in which they shot just 35%. Their rebounding continues to be strong. Grant and Williams have 22 of Xavier's 33 rebounds. Nover and Cheney have 13 of Indiana's 29 right now. Indiana just barely leading now by a scant 4 points.
Damon Bailey has replaced Todd Leary in the IU lineup, and inbounding will be Bailey against full court pressure. The pass comes to Pat Graham. Tad walks it down the floor as Xavier retreats. Then he gets it to the midcourt stripe. Gets it across the timeline to Greg Graham. Now to Calvert. 15-foot jump shot is around. No good. Tip up. No. Battle for the rebound. Batted away and pulled out of there by Xavier. The Musketeers within four and a chance to cut it down further. Here is Gladden on the right wing. Three try is no good. Rebound. Hawkins takes it out of there for Xavier. Hawkins with the basketball. Gets it out to Grant, outside to Gladden, to Aaron Williams, top of the key. Now the right side pass comes off to Tyrus Walker. Walker holds on the wing, then he drives. He pulls up, he bounces to Grant. Baseline jump shot is no good, and Calvert Chaney's got the board. Chaney clears to Greg Graham. Graham the other way to Bailey in the corner, drives it inside, puts it up, and nobody draw the foul. Damon really upset he didn't get the basket, but Walker was going to be called for the foul. The personal is on Tyrus Walker, his third. So three on Walker. Damon Bailey will go to the free throw line, and he'll try to take that lead up there to a little more comfortable margin of six if he can hit both free throws. Damon tonight, or this afternoon, we should say, with 5 points, two shots coming here. Bailey eyes the first attempt. Up it goes, and he got it. Big free throw there, his sixth point. 6:56 to go. The Hoosiers lead at 58-53. And the dogged Xavier Musketeers continue to make it everything but easy for Indiana. The second one is up and in. Bailey's got seven. The Hoosiers leads back up to six. 59-53. Hawkins with the basketball in backcourt. He slides it to the right side. Hawkins brings it outside to Jamie Gladden. Gladden drives right, gets to Hawkins. Three on the way is good. Michael Hawkins cans another big bucket. His first of the second half, however, and his third three of this ballgame. 59-56. Xavier.
6.5 minutes left and one three-point play would even it up.
Greg Graham. Graham back out to Pat. Pat Graham with the basketball now against Aaron Williams. Looks right. Fires it out to Greg Graham. Graham drives it left. Brings it back out to Calvert. Chaney now looks in. He drives left, spins, looks for help, gives it off to Damon Bailey. Bailey back out to Pat Graham, top of the key. Pat slides it left, bounces low to Damon. Inside posting play. The shot is blocked away. Out of bounds. Greg Graham has it. A nice save try by Gladden, but he batted it right to Greg Graham. Now left to Pat Graham. Down to the corner to Bailey. Shot in the air, no good. Rebound, Greg Graham. And a foul on Greg Graham. Greg Graham is asking Larry Lembo to ask the other official. Something was called beforehand. And Bob Knight is livid. Another official called something down low, and I don't know what happened, but Lembo involves himself in calling Graham for the foul. So Greg has picked up his third personal. And Xavier's got the ball back. Here is Hawkins. Hawkins. Pulls out, bounces to Aaron Williams. He drives the baseline and slams it in. Aaron Williams, 17th point. And this ball game suddenly is a one-point contest. 59-58. Here is Pat Graham. Pat looks it inside. Gives it to Bailey. Damon looks low, goes to Calvert. Chaney drives it left, gives to Pat Graham. Pat looks in, gives to Greg Graham. He drives in, puts it up, and missed the shot, but a foul. So Greg Graham will go to the line. And let's see who they nail the personal on. It's on Jamie Gladden. That is his second of the ball game. So it'll put Greg Graham at the free throw line. That's the 10th team foul on Xavier. 5:13 to go. The Hoosiers will have two shots every time a foul is committed from now on. Graham is at the stripe with 17 points. One of one from the line today. He fires this free one good. Greg Graham has 18 points, and he'll have one more shot coming. This has been some kind of tough ball game. Bob Knight and Larry Lembo are really jawing over there. Second shot by Graham is around, and he got it to fall. Greg Graham now has his 19th point. Here we go with Xavier with a basketball. Down by three, 61-58. Hawkins, left side to Tyrus Walker. Walker now. Brings it back on the left wing. Down low it goes to Gladden, who drives it inside. Lost the handle. Pat Graham retrieves the loose ball. Kicks it up, puts to Greg Graham. He drives it inside. Pulls up just to Calvert Chaney. He drives baseline, fires, and hits! Calvert Chaney, 17th
63, Xavier 58. Timeout call. The score with 4:41 to go. We'll be back after this 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Beaver Dam Inn in Monticello is the place for exquisite prime rib and scrumptious seafood. Visit Beaver's now for their nightly dinner specials, exceptional service, and delicious homemade soups. While you're there, ask about their catering and private party services. Located just south of the Norway Dam, everyone's eager to eat at Beaver's. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Call 583-8375. The Beaver Dam Inn.
Logansport Ford Lincoln Mercury, the affordability store, has the number one best-selling car in America. Plus, they have the number one best-selling truck in America. At Logansport Ford Lincoln Mercury has great selection, a pleasant atmosphere, affordable quality service, and guaranteed no high pressure. Their goal at Logansport Ford Lincoln Mercury is your total satisfaction. Nobody makes it more affordable than the Logansport Ford Lincoln Mercury store, located at the east end of the Logansport Mall.
We're here at the Hoosier Dome, 63-58, Indiana on top of Xavier, 4:41 to go, and Max, this one by no means is out of the woodwork.
Boy, you're right about that, Don. Xavier, I think, has really had a good defense against Indiana. Calvert Cheney has had no uncontested shots today, and as a result, he has had a tough time here in the second half. He's hit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2 out of 6 here in the second half. That last shot that he hit was probably the most open he's been all day, as they have put a chaser on him all day long. Greg Graham is 7 for 8 in this game, as Pat Graham is 4 for 5. So those two guys have really done a job in there as far as shooting percentage is concerned. Indiana with a little bit of a margin here.
Xavier will have a basketball. Inbounding will be Tyrus Walker, Gentry, Hawkins, Grant, and Williams, the lineup for Xavier. My apology, Gladwell will inbound, not Walker. Indiana has Greg Graham, Pat Graham, Cheney, Nover, and Bailey. Here is Hawkins with the ball across the timeline. Hawkins starts it to the left, drives it back to the right, pulls up, fires, missed it. Rebound, Calvert Cheney. Cheney pulls it out to Pat Graham. Pat will bring it up the floor. Pat now to Damon Bailey. Bailey in backcourt on the right side, circles toward the left. Goes left wing to Pat Graham, down low to Calvert. Calvert inside, fadeaway jump shot is no good. Tipped out and pulled out of there by Gladden. Gladden now brings it up court for Xavier. Now Gladden has it left wing to Gentry. Gentry right side to Hawkins. He fakes the three. Down low pass kicked by Nover, out of bounds. It'll belong to Xavier. Rob Knights telling Calvert Cheney that shot was much too quick and certainly not a good one on that last attempt. Here the inbound from the Xavier Musketeers. Gladden gets it into Grant to Gentry in backcourt. Gentry now with 3:58 to go, starts it left, pulls up on the wing, gives to Gladden. Gladden backs it back out, fires it off to Grant in backcourt. Grant holds, gives it back out to Gladden. Gladden against Pat Graham, fires it out to Gentry. Gentry starts it back to the right, 13 on the shot clock. Gentry, top of the key left, goes to Gladden. Gladden fires a long jump shot and got it. That's a 2, however. Gladden gets his 18th point of the ball game. Guy is a good shooter, and it is now 63-60. IU by 3. Damon Bailey with a basketball, top of the key. Bailey looks left side, gives it to Greg Graham on the wing. Greg looking for help, brings it back out, top of the key. Greg Graham goes left to Pat Graham. Pat on the dribble, lost the handle, scrambled for it, and the ball batted away, and Pat Graham comes up with it. Pat gives it off to Damon Bailey. The Hoosiers retain it. Here is Bailey driving it all the way, scooping it up, no, but a foul is going to be called on Xavier. Bailey driving hard to the basket, draws the foul on Steve Gentry. That'll be his 4th. So Bailey again will go to the free throw stripe for IU. 2:57 left. The Hoosiers lead by 3. Bailey with 2 shots coming. He's got 7 points in the game and his last 3, or he has hit his last 3 from the line. He's 3 of 4 on the day. Damon with 2 here. Every point seems like it is pressure-packed.
and he missed it. He'll have one more.
Indiana was 6 for 6 just before that miss.
So Bailey, with one more shot coming, will try to make it a 4-point lead. 2:57 remaining in this game. The second shot is good, and Damon Bailey's got his 8 point. The Hoosiers' lead is up to 4. Quickly down the floor, Hawkins for Xavier. Michael Hawkins on the move, left side, back out to Gentry. Now off to Gladden. Gladden on the dribble, past the pick, pulls up, can't get a shot away, still in the dribble, fires it out to Hawkins. Hawkins looks low, gets it to Brian Grant. Grant looks baseline, then brings it out to Hawkins with a pass. Hawkins on the wing, drives in the lane, pulls up, fires, and got the roll. Hawkins gets his 13th point. It's a 2-point contest. 64-62. 2:20 left. Damon Bailey with the ball on the left side. Bailey starts it low, then brings it back out to Pat Graham. Pat gets it to Calvert. Calvert Cheney inside. Scoop shot. Good! Calvert Cheney, a huge bucket, his 19th. Back down the floor quickly, Gladden for Xavier. Xavier's Gladden on the backcourt dribble, working on Greg Graham. Outside pass comes off to Gentry. Gentry, top of the key. Gentry starts it going to the left side. 4-point ball game, 66-62 IU. 1:49 left. Gentry on the wing, backs outside to Hawkins. A three on the way, partially blocked. Grant rebounds, puts it up and in. Brian Grant's got his 10th point. 66-64, 2-point game again. Back up the court, Damon Bailey. Bailey sets up the offense, looks at left. Now, Bailey looks for Calvert Cheney. Can't find him, they're holding on. Here's to Pat Graham, he turns around. Pat inside goes to Greg Graham, he turns, fires the shot, and he couldn't get it, rebound pulled out of there by Williams. 1:14 left, here comes Xavier again. Here's Gentry, right wing drive, baseline, pulls up, blocked, shot out of bounds, it'll belong to Xavier. Musketeers ball. Indiana is on defense, and it's a 2-point ball game. It's 66-64 with 1:06 left. Bob Knight's making a defensive change. He's bringing in Chris Reynolds. So Reynolds will check in for Pat Graham. Greg Graham will guide the inbounds pass from Jamie Gladden. Gladden gets it to Hawkins. Hawkins lost the handle. Picked up by Chris Reynolds. Reynolds, backcourt, slows it down to Greg Graham and back out to Chris Reynolds. Now to Cheney. Back out to Greg Graham. Off to Bailey. Damon directs traffic. We're down to 52 and a foul call on Aaron Williams. Aaron Williams commits the intentional foul on Bailey. That's his 4th personal, but they don't call it intentional naturally. We haven't seen that called since D-Day. Nevertheless, Indiana with free throws coming as the Hoosiers own a 2-point lead. And again, it's Damon Bailey who will go to the line. He'll have 2 shots coming. Bailey was 1 of 2 in his last trip. Prior to that, he'd hit 3 in a row. Bailey looking for his 9th point. He fires, he hits. Bailey's got 9. The crowd erupts. 51.6 seconds to go. Bailey will try to make it a 4-point Hoosier lead. He eyes, he flies, and it is. Damon Bailey's got 10. Indiana by 4. Gentry the other way for Xavier. Drives it left wing. Back outside to Williams. Right side to Grant. Grant gives to Gladden. Gladden moves it right to the baseline. And a whistle, we get a foul call. We have a foul call. However, it does not put anybody at the free throw line. The Hoosiers have committed just 4 team fouls. And that foul was on Nober, his 3rd. Indiana can get rid of a lot of fouls here. 2 more before they even put him at the line. The inbound goes to Williams. Williams into Hawkins. Hawkins fires a shot off the glass. No good. Rebound Grant. Blocked shot by Nover. Grant again. No good, but a foul. And they will put him at the line this time. The clock is down to 31 seconds to go. And Matt Nover picks up another. That's his 4th. So Nover now with 4 personal fouls. As Pat Graham will check back into the IU lineup now, and Chris Reynolds will go to the sideline.
Don Grant has got 16 rebounds in this game. And, of course, that last rebound he got was a monumental rebound for Xavier. It gave him a chance once again to get on the boards, because with a four-point lead, that means two possessions. And with only 31 seconds, you don't have that many possessions left.
Todd Leary comes in for Madden over, and Chris Reynolds sits down. So Bob Knight's getting his best free throw shooters in there. Todd Leary, Damon Bailey, Pat Graham, Greg Graham, and Calvert Chaney, the IU lineup. Brian Grant's at the free throw line, and the Hoosier crowd is really roaring. The free throw is up, and it is good. Brian Grant answers the call with his 11th point. He'll have one more shot coming. He can make it a two-point game again if he hits it. 31 seconds left. Grant fires up the second. It is way off the mark. Rebound, Calvert Chaney. Chaney is fouled almost immediately. 29 seconds to go. Madden over, and Chris Reynolds will check back in immediately. So Calvert Chaney will go to the free throw line. Calvert struggled from the line early. He was one of three, but he has hit his last two, and he's 3 for 5 from the ballgame now. Chaney with 19 points. 29 seconds to go. The Hoosiers lead by three, and Calvert Chaney will try to put it at least at a five-point lead or a four-point lead. He gets two cracks at it. These are big. Chaney takes a couple of dribbles, the deep breath, eyes the rim, fires it up, and got it. Chaney's got 20. Indiana's lead is up to four. Calvert will try to make it a five-point Hoosier advantage. The Heat's out, the senior All-American, and he comes through with the first. He's got one more left. He eyes. He flies. He hits. Calvert Chaney's 21st point, Indiana by five, and timeout call. 29 seconds to go, the Hoosiers. Just that far away from advancing to the third round in St. Louis of the Midwest Regional next Thursday. 70-65 our score. The Hoosiers on top of the Xavier Musketeers. And Max, boy, you got to give this team credit. They have played a whale of a ball game today. And I can tell you, the only time I saw them in person this year was against Evansville in the championship game of the MCC tournament. And I said right then and there, if they're in the tournament, I hope we get to play them. I'm sorry I made the statement.
Well, you know how teams are when they come up against Indiana. They give it their best shot. I just think they've really had a great game plan. They have really contained Chaney, although he scored a lot of points. And as a result, Indiana has had to use some other players. Unfortunately, they have responded. Well, Indiana's foul shooting, after a 1-4 start, they've had 10 of their last 11. And Don, I'm just checking here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They've been to the line 5 times in the last 5 minutes and have scored only 2 baskets during that period of time. And they've hit 9 out of 10. So that is really clutch shooting, as they have shot 90% during the last haul here. Boy, you've got to make them, and Calvert Chaney, the big guy, did.
Indiana comes back out of the floor with their defensive lineup. Madden over, Chris Reynolds, Damon Bailey, Greg Graham, and Calvert Chaney. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
WNJY, Delphi, Monticello, where Don Kennedy is your host for Big Band Jump. That's tonight at 6 o'clock here on Joy 103.
Now Xavier has put in Michael Hawkins, Steve Gentry, Aaron Williams, Brian Grant, and Jamie Gladden. Indiana with a five-point lead, 29 seconds to go. Indiana's not going to let him come up the floor unmolested.
Jamie Gladden has set a new school record for threes today. He was tied for it with 151 coming into this game. He's hit three today. I know they want one from him right now.
Aaron Williams will trigger the inbounds pass. Williams fires it up. It comes to Gentry. Gentry quickly across the midcourt line. To top of the key to Hawkins, who fires it down low to Gladden. Gladden drives. Block shot. Damon Bailey pulls it out. Bailey's got the ball and he's fouled. Beautiful job defensively by Indiana. I'm not at all sure who got the block, Max, but whoever it was, I think Madden over, maybe, yeah. Madnover blocked the shot, and Bailey pulled it out of there, and Damon will go to the line with 18.9 seconds left, and the Hoosiers can just about wrap it up if Bailey can the free ones. Damon has 10 points in the ball game. He's hit his last three, and he has hit six out of his last seven. So Bailey at the line. Two shots coming. He could make it a seven-point game if he connects on both. The first one is in the air, and it is no good. Calvert Chaney patted him on the chin, said, keep your chin up and hit the next one.
Well, Bailey's the only one that's missed a free throw here in the last 6 minutes.
Damon with one more. He takes a look, and he got it. Bailey's got 11. Now it's 2 3-point shots by Xavier just to tie. Hawkins drives it left, fires the three. Got it. Hawkins scores his 16th point. And here's the inbound now. Who is it? Bailey trying to get it in. Finally does to Greg Graham. It's knocked away. It'll be Indiana ball. We're down to 3 seconds to go.
Apparently they don't have any timeouts left. They couldn't stop the clock. It ran about 6 or 8 seconds.
Indiana allotted to run down as much as they could. Bailey almost didn't get it in, but Graham finally touched it, and it was batted out of bounds by Xavier. 3 seconds to go. Bailey will inbound. Damon looks. Here's Damon. Gets it into Calvert. Calvert is fouled immediately. And 2 seconds, make it 1.7 left, and Indiana's going to wrap it up. Calvert Chaney will go to the line with two shots. He needs only one to secure the victory. So Chaney will go to the stripe with 21 this afternoon. And this nail-biting, heart-pounding basketball game will be over with 1.7 seconds running off if he hits them both. Otherwise, it's got to be another three-point bomb if he doesn't hit either one for Xavier to win. And they bring in a new face, Mark Pointer, a 6'8 senior out of Cathedral High School here in Indianapolis. Pete Gillen getting this young man in the game here in his hometown. Calvert Chaney at the line. Eyes the first attempt. It is in the air. It's good. That's it. Calvert Chaney's 22nd point of the ball game, and Indiana has secured the victory, and timeout is called. Some hugs going on by the players right now. With 1.7 seconds left, Indiana owns a 4-point lead. Chaney will have a chance to add one more point to the board. And then, of course, they'll allow the clock to run out as Xavier will try to get it down floor. But it's really now, Max, there is no question. All Indiana's got to do is stay away from Xavier.
And I'm sure that's why Coach Knight called the timeout. He's telling him over there, whatever you do, don't foul somebody on a three-point shot in case Chaney were to miss, because that's the only possible way they could even tie it up. So it doesn't make a lot of difference now. All they've got to do is let them come down court, but Coach Knight not letting any little minute detail go unattended to, calls the timeout with just less than 2 seconds to make sure everybody knows, and now you can see what they're doing. Everybody's lining up at the other end of the court.
Well, Calvert comes back to the free throw line. The Musketeers have not come back onto the floor yet. Bailey, Pat Graham, Greg Graham, and Chris Reynolds. Greg Graham and Chris Reynolds, big smiles on their faces as they converse down at the other end. And Indiana is going to come up with a victory here this afternoon that will send them into the third round of the Midwest Regional. Indiana's hit on 12 of their last 14 from the line. So after a slow start here today, they have picked up the pace at the free throw stripe, and it's keyed them down the stretch. Indiana's Calvert Chaney was at the stripe now, and he will be there for one. So Calvert, with only two Xavier players there, Williams and Hawkins, as we await the TV timeout to run its course. The rest of the Xavier players are down the end of the floor. Well, give credit to Pete Gillen's ball club. They're going to wrap up their campaign 24-6. What a terrific season it has been. And they have done a great job in this ball game.
They have indeed. Indiana keeps its record perfect against Xavier. They were 6-0 coming into this game, having never lost to the Musketeers, and they're going to go away 7-0.
Now, I don't know what they're waiting for. It's got to be the longest timeout with a minute, 7 seconds to go in history.
CBS wants to get all of their prime commercials in while Indiana's still playing.
Bob Knight signaling his ball club to stay back. Calvert goes to the line. We're ready. Chaney with one more shot coming. Calvert puts it in the air and drills it. 23 for Calvert Chaney. Down the floor, long ball pass goes inside to Pointer, who will score at the buzzer, and that's the ball game. Indiana on to the Midwest Regional third round. The Hoosiers this afternoon, victors over the Xavier Musketeers. Pete Gillen and Bob Knight shaking hands at midcourt as Indiana wins it in a big, big ball game this afternoon here in the Midwest Regional at the Hoosier Dome. The final score, Indiana 73, Xavier 70. We'll be back after we pause for the 60-second network timeout.
The football players, the fans, and certainly the coaches expect IU to have a winning season. It takes 100% effort from everyone to make the season successful. Varsity Club members support this winning effort by their generous gifts to the scholarship fund for the football team and 17 other varsity sports. The athletic department receives no tax dollars to support the program. We pay the bills through the generosity of our fans. Help the Varsity Club have a winning season with your gift. With your 100% effort, along with the hard work of our players and coaches, how can we lose?
This is Beaver Dam Inn in Monticello is the place for exquisite prime rib and scrumptious seafood. Visit Beavers now for their nightly dinner specials, exceptional service, and delicious homemade soups. While you're there, ask about their catering and private party services. Located just south of the Norway Dam, everyone's eager to eat at Beavers. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Call 583-8375. The Beaver Dam Inn.
We're back once again at the Hoosier Dome here in Indianapolis, where Indiana wins the first game of today's doubleheader of the Midwest Regional. At this site, 73-70, the final score. The Hoosiers over Xavier's Musketeers in a terrific ball game this afternoon. Let's look at the individual scoring on today's game. First of all, for the Musketeers, under head coach Pete Gillen, who did a sensational job of preparing his ball club today, Steve Gentry scored 2 points. Jamie Gladden had 18. Brian Grant had 11. Aaron Williams had 17. Michael Hawkins, 16. Tyrus Walker had 4. And Mark Pointer had 2. Also playing but not scoring were Larry Sykes, Chris Mack, and Eric Edwards. So 4 players in double figures for Xavier, 18 for Gladden, 17 for Williams, 16 for Hawkins, and 11 for Brian Grant. For Indiana this afternoon, the Hoosiers were led by Calvert Chaney. The All-American had 23 this afternoon and a fine performance once again. Greg Graham had 19, 11 for Damon Bailey, 10 for Pat Graham, 6 for Matt Nover, 2 points for Chris Reynolds, 2 points for Todd Leary, Alan Henderson, and Brian Emmons played but did not score. So Indiana led by Calvert Chaney's 23, 19 from Greg Graham, 11 for Damon Bailey, and 10 for Pat Graham. We'll be back after we pause for the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
A law firm that believes integrity comes first. O'Brien and Morrissey wants you to know about their law practice located at 1015 Bank One Building in Lafayette. You can talk to Thomas O'Brien or Michael Morrissey with your first consultation free. They can assist you in divorce, personal injury, real estate, wills, estates, drunk driving, and criminal cases. Meeting the legal needs of the people in our area, O'Brien and Morrissey. Call 317-742-9027.
Chevy's, Logan Sports' most popular nightclub, invites you to rock and roll to the greatest hits of the 50s and 60s every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. Yes, Chevy's friendly atmosphere, unbelievable lighting, and outstanding sound makes for a good time for everyone. Now at Chevy's on Sunday night, it's country western night. So pull on the boots, get out the hat, and plan to dance the two-step at Chevy's. Whether you're looking for a little bit of country or a little bit of rock and roll, Chevy's has it. Located inside Meyer's Sport Bowl East, 1/2 mile east of the Logan Sport Mall.
Well, back once again to the Hoosier Dome in downtown Indianapolis, where Indiana wins this afternoon over the Xavier Musketeers 73-70.
The Musketeers end their campaign at 24-6. Indiana advances to the third round of this NCAA Tournament Midwest Regional as they win their 30th game of the season against just three defeats. And, of course, it's on to St. Louis next Thursday and Saturday, hopefully. Max, let's take a look at the team statistics on tonight's ball game, on this afternoon's ball game. We actually started this morning with our broadcast.
Well, Don, Indiana, for the first time in six games, has failed to shoot 50%. They end up shooting just 45% on 26 of 54. In the first half, they were 14 of 30, 46.7. The second half, they were 50% on 12 of 24. They were 26 of 54 for the game. For Xavier, they had a terrible first half shooting, 11 of 31, just 35%. They warmed things up a bit in the second half, shooting on 16 of 33, 48.5, giving them a game total of 27 of 64, 42%. So neither team was able to hit 50%, and I would have to think a lot of that was due to the defense thrown up by both teams, as this was a real battle out there defensively here this afternoon. From three-point range, Indiana finishes 3 of 7. All three of those coming in, they were 3 of 7 in the first half. They were 3 of 10 for the game. All of their three-point shots that they made occurred in the first half, 30% shooting. For Xavier, they were 7 of 17, and that really helped them. They were 3 of 5 in the first half and 4 of 9 in the second half. That's 41% shooting, as we mentioned. Jamie Gladden, their fine little guard, this afternoon connected on three of them, giving him 154 totally for his career, and that's a new Xavier record. From the free throw line, Indiana's had a hard time getting started. In the first half, they were only 4 of 7. They were only one of their first four, but they hit 14 of 19 in the second half, including something like 12 of 14 at the end. It gave them a 18 of 26 for 64.2 record from the shooting percentage from the free throw line. For Xavier, they finished 6 of 9, 67% in the first half, 3 of 5 in the second, 60%, 9 of 14 for the game, 64%. The bank boards were controlled today by Xavier with 42 rebounds. Indiana finished with 36, but Indiana did come in closer in the second half, losing it by an 18 to 20 margin. But individually today, Calvert Chaney finishes 8 of 17 from the field, as I thought Xavier did an excellent job on him, putting someone on him who had no other responsibilities except to stay with Calvert, try to keep the ball away from him if they could. He certainly had no uncontested shots today. Matt Nover, 3 of 5. Greg Graham, outstanding shooting today. After a 2 of 8 game on Friday, he was 7 of 9 today. Damon Bailey still struggling with his shooting. He was 2 of 6 Friday, just 2 of 8 today. Chris Reynolds likewise. He was 1 of 3 today. Todd Leary was 1 of 3. Pat Graham came through, 4 of 5. That's to go with a 3 of 5 on Friday. So he's 7 of 12 for tournament play. Brian Evans, after a good game Friday, was 0 for 2 this afternoon. Michael Hawkins finished 6 of 12 for Xavier from the field. Aaron Williams, 6 of 13. Brian Grant was 5 of 13, Steve Gentry 1 of 5, and Jamie Gladden finished 6 of 16 from the field here this afternoon. The rebounding honors Nover and Chaney with 8 each to lead Indiana. Bailey had 1, but he did have 3 assists. By the way, Matt Nover had 3 block shots, and Chaney had 1 block shot. Also, Greg Graham also with 1 block shot. Brian Evans finished with 4 rebounds. Bailey had 3 assists, and Chris Reynolds had 4 assists. Greg Graham had 3 assists also, as Pat Graham had a couple. The leading rebounder, however, was Brian Grant with 16 big rebounds today. He also had 2 blocks, and Williams had 10 rebounds. He likewise had 2 blocks to lead Xavier. So that's the way the statistics look in this basketball game, Don. Indiana's largest lead was a 13-pointer coming in the first half at 32-19 when Xavier went nearly 6 minutes without scoring from the field that allowed Indiana to build up that margin. Xavier cut it down to four at halftime by a count of 35-31. There was one tie game. That came at 39-all. And then Indiana went on a real charge that built it back up to a nine-point lead at 51-42. But it got down as close as 1 point at 59-58. And that was as close as they ever got again, as Indiana converted on free throws at the end, and they win it by three, 73-70.
Well, a giant win for this Indiana ball club, and as we indicated earlier, it puts them at 30-3 for the season. Xavier finishes their campaign at 24-6, but the most important factor involved, Indiana's on to the third round of this NCAA tournament in the Midwest Regional, and they'll play the winner of the second ball game here this afternoon. It's between Louisville's Cardinals and the Cowboys of Oklahoma State University. So Indiana will know late this afternoon who their opponent in St. Louis will be in the first round ball game, or third round ball game rather, on Thursday night of this coming week. Our ball game today has been brought to you in part by Indiana Gas. For efficiency, comfort, and a cleaner environment, natural gas is your best energy value season after season. By your local Napa Auto Parts store. Napa, because there are no unimportant parts. By your local Amoco Certicare Repair Centers. By the Hoosier Lottery, where you've got to play to win. By State Farm Insurance, with the more than 500 State Farm agents throughout Indiana, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By the real estate professionals at the 121 Century 21 offices in Indiana. By True Value Hardware. Got a tough job? You can do it with True Value Hardware stores. And by Squadron Herbicide for a higher level of soybean weed control. Our special thanks today to our studio producer, Gary Klein, and to our statistician, Joe Smith. Now this is Don Fisher for Max Skirvin inviting you to stay tuned next for the IU postgame show. We'll be rejoining you in just a couple of minutes. So long, everybody.
It's been Hurrying Hoosiers exciting basketball here on WNJY Joy 103. You'll want to stay tuned for the postgame with Don Fisher. It's all IU excitement, and it's all right here on Joy 103.
Beaver Dam Inn in Monticello is the place for exquisite prime rib and scrumptious seafood. Visit Beaver's now for their nightly dinner specials, exceptional service, and delicious homemade soups. While you're there, ask about their catering and private party services. Located just south of the Norway Dam, everyone's eager to eat at Beaver's. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Call 583-8375. The Beaver Dam Inn.
Logansport Ford Lincoln Merkley, the affordability store, has the number one best-selling car in America. Plus, they have the number one best-selling truck in America. At Logansport Ford Lincoln Merkley has great selection, a pleasant atmosphere, affordable quality service, and guaranteed no high pressure. Their goal at Logansport Ford Lincoln Merkley is your total satisfaction. Nobody makes it more affordable than the Logansport Ford Lincoln Mercury Store, located at the east end of the Logansport Mall.
Goody Sports Center is always bleeding red for the Indiana Hoosiers, and they'll bleed red for you too. Goody Sports Center, located in downtown Monticello, is your total sporting goods headquarters, even if your favorite colors aren't red and white. If it has anything to do with sports, Goody's has it. Whether it's shoes, sweats, jackets, or any kind of sports equipment, you can get it at Goody Sports Center. Goodies, located in the Shoppers Concourse, 103 South Main in downtown Monticello. Call 583-3009.
McGreevy's Pizza King, a place where your lunch hour is your time. Come in, sit down and relax. Choose from a large selection of super sandwiches, delicious salads, and sensational soups. Let them bring the food to you. McGreevy's Pizza King wants you to enjoy your lunch hour. For your next lunch break, enjoy McGreevy's Pizza King on the square in Delphi. McGreevy's Pizza King, more than just great pizza.
Professional interiors, what does that mean? Well, according to Funk and Wagnall, professional means skilled in a profession, art, or craft. Interior means pertaining to the inside. Now, what it doesn't mean is expensive. At Professional Interiors, you'll find the best prices on the best brands of carpet anywhere. So don't be surprised if you find that high-quality carpet that you saw elsewhere and thought you couldn't afford, priced so low that you'll wonder how the other guy sells any of it. Professional Interiors, 570 South Main Street,
Carpet in Monticello. The best carpet and better prices.
From Indianapolis, this is Don Fisher along with Max Skirvin with the IU postgame show, a review of today's ball game in which Indiana was a winner 73-70 over the Xavier Musketeers. Norm Gallenberger joined us on the postgame show. This may be your least enjoyable postgame show, Norm. I don't know if you can hear anything that we're saying, but congratulations on the fine win.
Well, if nobody else can hear us, it'll probably be the best show we've had all year. You know, I'm just sitting here thinking, I don't know whether I'm happiest or whether I'm more relieved. I think I'm more relieved than I am happy right now. I'm glad that booger's over with.
I'll tell you what, Xavier comes in and plays you as tough as anybody has this year. They were well prepared, and Pete Gillen does a great job.
One of the things that Coach Knight really attempted to, and I don't know how much he got it done, but really wanted to impress on our guys, and he told them, I bet if he told them once, he told them 10 different times over the last 2 days, is the fact that this outfit will play 40 minutes. It won't make any difference what the score is, that they will play you 40 minutes. And he has a lot of respect for the Xavier program and the coach and the way they do things and the way they, you know, how hard their players play. And they, you know, that outfit sure did themselves proud today.
Obviously, Indiana did itself proud as well, however, because Xavier kept coming at you all day long. I thought that Xavier really tried to control Indiana's running game today. They played a zone press a lot of the time. It wasn't something with a lot of pressure, but it just made you work to get the ball down the floor every time.
Well, it's certainly a known fact after people scout you for 35 ball games in the entire season that they know that we're a better basketball team and more potent when we're running than we are when we're walking it down the court. And that's what that three-quarter court press will do. You know, it'll keep you quiet. And although we did finally there, Chris Reynolds came off the bench in the first half and along with Pat Graham and sparked us through that thing. Then it didn't bother us that much the rest of the way. And they finally went to a man-to-man press after we kind of solved the thing. But more than anything else, you know, the different momentum swings in the game that where we'd done ourselves in, you know. I mean, we had Pat Graham had a couple fouls on guys shooting where they were shooting bad shots, and Greg Graham did a couple things early, and you know, we were our own worst enemy, and got really we'd get up 6, 8, 10, 11 points, and we'd get sloppy, and you can't do that against this outfit.
All right, we'll be back with more on our postgame show in a moment, but first let's pause for the 60-second timeout.
Future lawyer and Indiana University student Donna Moore.
With law, you can see direct change from some of the work that you do, and you see how people benefit.
Thanks to donors who give scholarships to Indiana University through the IU Foundation, our communities will have skilled professionals like Donna.
Being a mother of twins, finances were a big concern. I was really questioning whether I was going to go to graduate school, and I decided to go ahead and go for it. Without help, I probably would not have gotten as far as I've gotten.
Good luck, Donna, from the Indiana University Foundation.
A law firm that believes integrity comes first. O'Brien and Morrissey wants you to know about their law practice located at 1015 Bank One Building in Lafayette. You can talk to Thomas O'Brien or Michael Morrissey with your first consultation free. They can assist you in divorce, personal injury, real estate, wills, estates, drunk driving, and criminal cases. Meeting the legal needs of the people in our area, O'Brien and Morrissey. Call 317-742-9027.
Good afternoon, Indiana wins over Xavier, 73-70. And Norm Ellenberger on our postgame show, I think one of the real keys in today's ball game was getting off to the good start, and Greg Graham certainly got you off in that way as far as the early going. Then he got into some foul trouble, had to sit down for the rest of the first half.
He had a great start. You know, if you ever want to start, that's the way to do it. and then we needed that in the second half, but we didn't get it. But that's a mute point now. And the fact is that, you know, what Greg was able to do, he didn't shoot well. He was, like we talked, I think, like he was an old Model T crank. He didn't feel well at all in that first ball game with his shot. And we came over and shot yesterday for about 20 minutes and worked on him a little bit. He got that baby straightened out and really shot well afterwards.
Again, you got good performances off the bench today in the first half especially.
There were about 6 or 7 minutes, 8 minutes there that got us a lead. And then they couldn't hold it. After a timeout, it slowed us down, and we had Allen in there yet, and Allen hasn't quite decided what he can do and what he can't do, and he didn't. But that's certainly to be inspected, and not that it was his fault, but I'm just saying that, you know, he's got a ways to go yet. But that was a great bench. Todd Leary played some great defense.
Norm, one of the things that it seemed to me Xavier did a good job with was containing Chaney today by putting a man on him, but he apparently had nothing else to do but that.
Well, they had a couple guys that wore Chaney like a second skin. I mean, they face guarded him, they bumped him, but that Calvert's been used to a lot of that, but not quite with such a quick guy. They had, smaller players, and he had a heck of a time getting open. And then if the game is called, and I'm not complaining at the officiating, it was called both the same way on both ends. When it's called, when people can hang on you a little bit, it's tough. Coach spent a large portion of the halftime figuring out a way to get Chaney the ball, and we got him the ball a little bit more in the second half.
The other thing, in the second half, you changed your players' personnel so that your matchups were a little bit different, which seemed to me presented problems maybe at both ends of the court. Certainly Williams at one time was trying to guard Bailey, and they were out at the 10-second line.
Well, we wanted to do that, and Bob said that our offense, you know, when your offense isn't functioning like we'd like it for it to, why, let's create some matchup problems. Plus, that little smaller lineup that we went with give them a little bit more problem with that zone press.
One of the things I think that's awfully important, however, is the mental toughness that this team, I think, continues to exhibit.
You know, we've been in this position before this year, you know, in games, and you know, maybe not one. This is a whole season in itself. Every time you play a game, you know, from here on out, it's not a game, it's a whole season, because you know, there's nothing after that. So down to the wire, I thought we had held our composure very well, and these kids want to go on.
Well, Norm, we congratulate you. Again, this is the time of the year when you get no rest. You got preparation to do already. You don't know who you're going to play in the next ball game on Thursday, but you are going to St. Louis, and that's the important thing.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of folks not going to make any more trips.
All right.
And I'm tickled to death that we're not one of them.
All right. Norm Ellenberger, our guest on the post-game show, as always. We'll be back with some final thoughts right after we pause for the 60-second timeout.
Chevy's, Logan Sports' most popular nightclub, invites you to rock and roll to the greatest hits of the 50s and 60s every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. Yes, Chevy's friendly atmosphere, unbelievable lighting, and outstanding sound makes for a good time for everyone. Now at Chevy's on Sunday night, it's country western night. So pull on the boots, get out the hat, and plan to dance the two-step at Chevy's. Whether you're looking for a little bit of country or a little bit of rock and roll, Chevy's has it. Located inside Meyer's Sport Bowl East, 1/2 mile east of the Logan Sport Mall.
A law firm that believes integrity comes first. O'Brien and Morrissey wants you to know about their law practice located at 1015 Bank One Building in Lafayette. You can talk to Thomas O'Brien or Michael Morrissey with your first consultation free. They can assist you in divorce, personal injury, real estate, wills, estates, drunk driving, and criminal cases. Meeting the legal needs of the people in our area, O'Brien and Morrissey. Call 317-742-9027.
Well, for the final time this afternoon here at the Hoosier Dome, Indiana, a winner 73-70 over the Xavier Musketeers, as Hoosier fans across the state breathe a sigh of relief from a very well-played ball game by Xavier. Xavier this afternoon had four players in double figures. Their leading scorer was Jamie Gladden with 18. Aaron Williams had 17, 16 for Michael Hawkins, and Brian Grant with 11. Then for Indiana today, 23 for Calvert Chaney, 19 for Greg Graham, 11 for Damon Bailey, and 10 for Pat Graham.
Well, Indiana finishes shooting 48%. Xavier finished shooting 42%. Indiana hit 13 of their last 15 free throws. That's almost 87%. That's after a 1-4 start. Damon's points from the second half, most of them were 11 points. In fact, all, I guess, were in the second half. Off the bench, Indiana got 14 points from its bench today, including four rebounds, six assists, and a couple of steals. And certainly some key plays in this game. Reynolds steal with 1:01 to go. Indiana leading 66-64 with a big play. Damon hit a couple of free throws with 51. And then at the end, two key defensive blocks, Nover and Greg Graham. And that made things easier for Indiana as they end up winning it. And Don, I guess now's the time to talk about this. Indiana University now has announced the sales procedure for its 1,000 ticket allotment to the NCAA Midwest Regional on Thursday and Saturday. For the public and faculty and staff, the athletic department will accept orders only from season ticket holders for a maximum of 2 tickets each. Each ticket is $60, and you add a $2 handling charge per ticket. All tickets will be allocated and assigned by the university priority point system. Orders will be taken Sunday from 6 to 9. That's tonight, 6 to 9. Tomorrow from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m., either in person or by telephone. The telephone number 1-800-447-4648 or 812-855-4006 or at the Assembly Hall North Lobby Box Office. For IU students, any student with a valid ID should come to Assembly Hall on Monday from 7, with the doors opening at 7, it says p.m., but, well, maybe it is p.m. Monday evening with the doors opening at 7 p.m. to be included in the lottery drawing at 8 p.m. Tours Indiana University Alumni Association will sponsor a land package only. All tour representatives will be located in Assembly Hall's I-Man's Lounge, South Section, Sunday from 6 to 9 p.m. and all day on Monday. So that's the way you get tickets for the 1,000 that are allotted Indiana.
Now, very briefly, I'd like to inform all of our affiliate stations along the line. We would like you to stay tuned after our broadcast this afternoon, about 45 seconds after we finish up our broadcast, just in a couple of seconds here. We would like you to listen to our broadcast channel in audition. We have some important information to pass along to our affiliate stations, so all of the board ops of our affiliate stations, please stand by. Keep us in queue on your boards locally so that you can hear the information that we want to pass along to you once we conclude our regular broadcast today. It is information for each of your general managers for tomorrow morning. So again, it'll only take about a minute, and we hope that you will stay with us as soon as this broadcast is concluded, and we will feed that information down the satellite channel. Keep us in audition. Well, the ball game today, again a final. Indiana wins it over Xavier, 73-70. The Hoosiers on to St. Louis for the Midwest Regional third round against the winner of this afternoon's second game here at the Dome between the Louisville Cardinals and the Oklahoma State Cowboys. Indiana now 30-3 in the campaign. Xavier closes out an outstanding year, 24-6. We again will join our affiliate stations board ops here in about a minute. Until then, for Joe Smith and Max Kerwin, we'll talk to you on Thursday. This is Don Fisher. So long, everybody.
The music that's at home